tonight from the Pan American Center in Las Cruces. The Aggies of New Mexico State try to improve to 6-0 at home tonight. They welcome in the 49ers of Long Beach State. NF State is on a roll. 4 straight wins overall, undefeated record here at home. On the other hand, Long Beach State is looking to snap an 8-game losing streak as they play their 9th straight game away from home. And with that, we say hello from Lou Henson Court alongside former NM State assistant Russ Bradford, Adam Young with you. Well, this isn't your typical 1-8 opponent here tonight for NM State. Long Beach State was picked to win the Big West in the preseason. They've already played 4 ranked teams, and they have the toughest non-conference strength of schedule in America.
It's just unbelievable how brutal Long Beach State's schedule has been. They've played North Carolina, Kansas, UCLA, just to start Wichita State. And so this is a really battle-toughened team. I think the Aggies have their hands full tonight.
Both the Aggies and 49ers only have one senior on their roster. For the Aggies, that lone senior is the floor general, Ian Baker.
He's smooth, he's cool, he can shoot threes. He's very dangerous in a lot of different ways. He hasn't shot a great percentage yet this year, Adam, but I expect him to get on track tonight.
The 49ers have 3 Division I transfers, including Gabe Levin, who paces them in scoring and rebounding.
He's a Chicago area player. He started off at Loyola Marymount, where he started every game as a freshman, transferred. He's strong, he's reasonably quick, he can shoot the three, a very versatile big man for Long Beach State.
Tonight is the 41st all-time meeting here between the Aggies and the 49ers. They were rivals in the Big West Conference from 1984 through 2000, and Long Beach State hasn't won in this building in 11 tries. NM State looks to push their record to 7-2 as they seek their 5th straight win. Aggies, 49ers, it comes your way next.
And here we have 1893 from the makers of Pepsi Cola. I'm gonna swirl it. I'm gonna smell it. I'm just gonna take one small sip.
Kinda seemed like more than a sip.
Yeah, let me show you. Refined.
1893, made with cola nut extract and real sugar. Boldly blended colas.
For Vegas-style action, play the hottest table games now at the casino at Sunland Park. Go all in for a great time with exciting electronic blackjack and stay, hit, or play your way to winning big. Or place your bets on electronic roulette, where a jackpot could be yours with any spin of the wheel. Vegas-style action, baby, you bet. Let your hot streak begin. The casino at Sunland Park, I-10 to Sunland Park, exit 13. Play responsibly. Helpline 1-800-572-1142.
Introducing a more pleasurable way to buy a car. Get a low-rate auto loan from White Sands Federal Credit Union, even before you walk on the lot. White Sands Federal Credit Union, the difference is black and white. Introducing First Checking, a free checking account for kids between 13 and 17 years old. A First Checking account can help you teach your kids financial literacy. White Sands Federal Credit Union, the difference is black and white.
Welcome into the Pan American Center in Las Cruces alongside former NM State assistant coach Russ Bradford Adam Young, great to have you with us. Adam State looking for their fifth win in a row. This is game two for them in a three-game homestand. The Aggies are 6-2. Long Beach State playing the toughest non-conference schedule in the country, and they are 1-8 on the year. How about the job Paul Weir has done already, just 8 games into his head coaching career collegiately? Paul Weir has done some big things already. Just 2 games ago, a road win at San Diego, and the Aggies are coming off an 8-point home win Wednesday versus Air Force. It was the first win over a Mountain West school other than New Mexico since 2001 for the men's basketball program. Paul Weir only has one senior this year, so a lot of guys are back next year. And the lone senior is his starting point guard, Ian Baker. He's the floor general. City Endears had a great sophomore year. The Aggies go with 4 guards. Watch out for Eli Chua down low. Only played 7 minutes per game last year. Chua is averaging 8 points per game as a redshirt sophomore. The bench boss for Long Beach State is now in his 10th year. Dan Munson, previously the head coach at Gonzaga from 97 through 99. And he also had a stint at Minnesota from 99 through 2007. And Dan Munson, back in 1999, took Gonzaga to the Elite Eight. He is the all-time wins leader at Long Beach State University. He also only has one senior. That's Anson Moyer. He doesn't play much, so his lineup, at least the starters, no seniors. Watch out for Gabe Levin. We profiled him during the Open. They have 2 Loyola Marymount transfers. One is Gabe Levin. One is Evan Payne, who's going to come off the bench. And Justin Bibbins, he's the man that makes Long Beach State go. He's their point guard, and he was second team All Big West last season as a sophomore. This is the second straight year that the Aggies and the 49ers meet. We were in Long Beach last year at the Pyramid. The Walter Pyramid, one of the better college basketball venues around the country. Long Beach State is in the Big West Conference, black and gold their school colors, and a couple of famous alums right there. How about Steven Spielberg? He went to Long Beach State University right there in Long Beach, California. Now Russ Bradford, New Mexico State looking for their 5th straight win. How does Paul Weir's team do it here tonight?
Well, the most important thing, I think, Adam, is that they've got to take Long Beach State seriously. I think that's a big key to the game, is that Long Beach is a lot better than their record. They've played a brutal schedule, the best schedule in America, and it's no disgrace to be 1-9 considering who they've played. So I'd say that's the first thing, is not to think it's going to be a day at the beach, if you'll excuse the pun. Second, they're going to have to get back and contain Justin Bibbins. He hasn't had a great year shooting-wise, but he's very explosive on the fast break. He's an experienced point guard. He's a first-team all-conference pick going into the season. And finally, they're going to have to pound the Aggies off to pound the offensive rebounds. They've done a great job of that up to this point. And it's really, nothing makes your offense look better than when you grab it and stick it back in the basket.
You mentioned the schedule for Long Beach State. Of their 8 losses, 6 have been against premier programs. They have losses to Wichita State, North Carolina, Louisville, UCLA, Washington, and then most recently on Tuesday, they fell by 30 at Kansas. Now, Russ, this is their 9th game in a row away from Long Beach. How will travel affect them tonight, you think?
Well, I think it could go either way. They could be weary and just anxious to get home, but they're due for a win. And, beating North Carolina or Kansas would have been a huge upset, but this should be an evenly matched game. This is a team that, Dan Monson, who we see there, has taken this team to the NCAA tournament several times. He's the winningest coach in school history. And it's a school with Jerry Tarkanian, Lute Olson, Tex Winter, all on there, Seth Greenberg, who's now on ESPN.
Yeah.
I mean, and he's won more games than any of them.
Dan Munson's father is Don Munson, who was the head coach in Idaho and Oregon for a while. They are the preseason favorite in the Big West. We have the preseason favorite in the Big West against the preseason favorite in the WAC here tonight. This is a really, really good mid-major game here on Lou Henson Court. Aggies getting ready. Long Beach already on the court. 41st all-time meeting here between the Aggies and the 49ers. It was a 14-point win for the 49ers last year in Long Beach. NM State trying to make it 12 straight wins against Long Beach State here inside the Pan American Center. They had some battles back in the day. 84 through 2000 is when the Aggies and the 49ers were both in the Big West Conference. About to tip this one up. NM State trying to go to 7-2. Gabe Levin and Eli Chua
with the opening tip, and the opening tip is batted out of bounds. And it's going to go to Long Beach State. So we'll get our first look at Long Beach State, kind of an enigma because of the schedule they play. They're averaging 70 points per game, but they're allowing 86 on the year.
Well, it's clearly a philosophical decision by the coaching staff or the administration to play as difficult a schedule as they possibly can to get ready for Big West play. And if Dan Monson, who we'll see here, is already calling the referees over, he's made a philosophical decision to play this kind of schedule. But he comes back, you know, with a losing record, but a battle-toughened team.
They've traveled now 15,000-plus miles during this nine-game road swing. On the wing, Gabe Levin, one of two transfers in from Loyola Marymount. This is Javonte Jackson, who's only a freshman from Compton, California. A foul away from the ball. It's offensive on Long Beach. It's on Temedayo Youssef, a sophomore from Oakland.
Aggies opening up in a man-to-man to start the game, Adam.
Defensively for the Aggies, pretty much the same as last year, but the improvement has been on the offensive end, where the Aggies scored 78 on Wednesday against a good defensive Air Force team. And the Aggies are averaging 73 points per game. And they have four guards in right now. The only front court player is Eli Chua. Good pressure from Bibbins on City Endear. Seven on the shot clock for Endear. Splits defenders. Euro step. Throws it off the knee of Jackson. No reset in the shot clock. It's going to stay with the Aggies with one to shoot.
Now, Adam, I was in Ireland last year. Are we calling it the Euro step this year?
Euro step,
I like
step,
that.
Yeah.
I think that's actually a really smart name for it, because it's sort of that pause, slow down. It's nearly a travel, but it's not. The Euro step.
Quick trigger for Chua, and he hits the three. Eli Chua, his first made three this year. Just how Paul Weir drew it up, right, Russ?
Well, they had the shot clock against him.
Reversal there for Javonte Jackson, who's averaging 4 points per game. Chua for Braxton Huggins. He's improved this year as well. Working on Jordan Griffin, who's only a freshman. Weave handoff to Baker. Double team comes. Good hedge there by Levin. Under 10 to shoot again for the Aggies. Braxton Huggins going to work. Bump by Levin, no call. In the corner, City Endier fades and misses shallow. Rebound to Bibbins, who averages four a game. Good cut there by Youssef. And he finishes, slipping right there.
Well,
Temedayo Youssef.
Sorry, Adam, not a great sign that Long Beach laying the ball in twice to start the game. And that's not a good sign for the Aggies. Need to take these guys seriously. This is a tough team that's been some very difficult places to play, and they're not afraid of the Aggies. I can promise you that.
Well, we are frustrated. He calls a timeout early to talk to his team, and he's going to sub in a few guys as well. There's our officials, Tommy Nunez, Jeff Wooden, and Ruben Ramos. The thing about Paul Weir, and Marvin Menzies did this to an extent, but Paul Weir plays a ton of guys. If you're on the roster, there's a chance you're going to play each and every night, no matter what the opponent is.
That's right, and I think it's one of his strengths, both as for Marvin as well as Paul Weir, is that they're both excellent recruiters, and why not use your bench if you've got 10 of them, and they're sort of doing it by committee. I think Long Beach is doing the same thing, except for their guards. The teams are in some ways very similar. Their strength is their backcourt. Big guys are a lot younger, as we take a look at Ian Baker.
NM State has a walk-on. Joe Garza, who's from Las Cruces. There he is, number 15 in white. He scored 11 points in just 8 minutes Wednesday. Crucial minutes against Air Force. And Joe's a walk-on who was a practice player for the women's program the last couple of years. And Paul Weir reached out to him. Joe Garza now on the Aggie roster, and he's made an impact as a walk-on, a local kid.
It's a terrific story, and you know, he played for Will Benjamin, the Aggie great. But I will say that, you know, Mark Track, as you know, I think I'm a big Mark Track fan, the women's coach. It must have made Joe a lot better player.
Yeah.
Because he came out shooting the ball.
Youssef again, blocked away by Chua, and it's going to stay with the 49ers.
Well, only by a great effort by Chua. Watch him recover here, but it would have been the third layup in a row for Long Beach.
Justin Bibbins from the corner swishes in the three. He's an awfully good player. Not shooting as well this year as he did last year. He's 44% from three coming into this year, and he's just 27% this year. 7-3, 49ers. Pull up for Huggins for the foul line. That's off the mark. Saved by Bibbins to Levin for Long Beach State. Bibbins, not a big guy. He's only 5'8". Does a lot of things well, but he has two made threes. Junior from Carson, California. Huggins trying to answer. He does.
Well, a difficult shot by Huggins because the pass came to his knees and he still recovered and shot it in. Generally, you tell a player, don't shoot that if it's not a good pass to your chest, but Huggins had plenty of time to knock that one in.
A&M State shot 7 of 13 from 3 in the second half in the win against Air Force Wednesday. Griffin misfires. Rebound tip to Chua. Griffin fell on that three-point try from the corner. Hesitation for Baker. Runs over the defender, but a foul is called. And it's going on Bibbins.
Well, the Aggies, look a little lethargic coming out of the block here. And I just hope they didn't think this would be an easy game. I know the coaches didn't.
And a lot of these guys for the Aggies saw Long Beach last year in Long Beach. They played in that game. It's a little different Long Beach team, but a lot of those guys are back for them as well. Garza enters for Jamario Jones, who's in for the first time. Multi-dimensional junior from Memphis. He'll JUCO transfer. Teardrop short for Baker. Jones got his paws on it. And then it's pulled in by Justin Bibbins. Bibbins looking for a shot early. He also averages a team-high 4 assists per game this year.
Yep.
Tipped away by Jones and then off Bibbins.
Well, this is what is so impressive about Jamario Jones is he does everything. He made a couple threes. He doesn't do anything great, Adam, but he does everything pretty well, and he brings great hustle and energy to the court.
And he's one of those guys, too, that almost gets more energy and more attention by feeding his teammates, not necessarily scoring himself. He enjoys giving the ball up more than he scores. And you don't find many of those guys nowadays.
No, that's right. And Jalen Penny's sort of in the same mold, a player with no position but every position. We see Jonathan Wilkins into the game.
Oh, Weir's already gone deep. Unofficially, 10 guys already seeing action for the Aggies. The only guys in uniform that haven't played so far, Bular, Ellis, and Taylor. Three for Bibbins, looking for his third main. Defensive rebound for Jamario Jones. Jermaine Haley for Baker on the dribble drive. There's Jamario. Two pump fakes, hits the side of the backboard, gets his own miss, fights up and gets fouled. And Jamario Jones will get two free throws when we come back from break. Jamario bringing some energy. The Aggies trail Long Beach State 10-6. A&M State looking for their fifth win in a row and looking for a 6-0 home start to the campaign.
On the field.
In the pool.
On the court.
We wear our game faces under the lights.
But sometimes our toughest opponents aren't wearing a uniform.
Instead, we confront them internally.
Mental illness affects 1 in 4 adults in the United States.
Suicide is the second leading cause of death among college students.
If you or someone you know is fighting a silent battle, please speak up and ask for help.
You are not alone.
Wells Fargo is making changes to make things right. First, all customers who have been impacted will be fully refunded. Second, a confirmation will be sent when new personal or small business checking, savings, or credit card accounts are opened. Third, we've eliminated product sales goals for our retail bankers to ensure your interests are put first. We're taking action. We're renewing our commitment to you.
We'll be right back. good Aggie student section tonight at the Pan American Center. Lou Henson Court, Long Beach State with a four-point advantage early. NM State under first-year head coach Paul Weir, and these guys love playing for him. Here's the thoughts from senior point guard Ian Baker.
I think the thing that Coach P have changed the most about the squad is just holding everybody to, you know, a high standard, holding everyone accountable. I know in the last couple of years we were just, you know, kind of able just to get by, but this year, you know, he's just making everybody have more of a serious approach to the game.
I'll tell you what, Coach, whenever Marvin Menzies was hired by UNLV, all the support for Paul Weir started coming in from the players, from the community, from coaches around the country. He was the right guy for the job.
Well, it was a landslide, and I think Mario Mochia recognized that early. It was really a smart move. He's popular, great recruiter, and it did seem like the right move. I know the players are excited about it, and there's a real buzz around town about Paul Weir.
Loyal, too. He spent 9 years here as an assistant, 5 as an associate head coach. Jones gets 1 of 2. Long Beach State, 4 of 7, shooting 2 of 4 from long range. It's a three-point ball game. Long Beach State trying to snap an 8-game losing streak. Freshman Jordan Griffin can really shoot it from the arc. Back out to Bibbins, who's already made 2 threes. One dribble for Levin. Pulls up and swishes in the jumper. He can really shoot it at 6'7".
Well, that's his reputation. It's calm and cool and completely unfrantic and takes his time. He looked really smooth there.
Matt Taylor, his first minutes. Chucks it out, stolen away. Jackson over Haley, and it's a charge on Javonte Jackson. This is what Paul Weir wants too, toughness. And when you draw charges, that usually relies on toughness.
Chua just at the, you know, it's hard to find big guys that'll stand up and take that hit like that. There's Jermaine Healy.
Pretty big guard though, 6'7". Down low is Jamario Jones, met at the rim. That was LaRod Williams. Bibbins to Levin. Back out Bibbins, left wide open. Aggies catch a break. Rebound tip to Endier. The Aggies pushing, numbers 3-on-2. The bounce for Jamario Jones, up and under. Finger roll, what a finish. Not a good post feed by the freshman Jordan Griffin. Haley ahead to Wilkins, and it's tipped out of bounds and last touch by Wilkins. Jonathan trying to say it was off on LaRod Williams.
Well, a risky pass by Haley, but he had the right idea. John Wilkins might have been open. Watch Wilkins trying to sneak by. One thing Jonathan Wilkins does really well is run the floor. And look at him go here. He beats everybody down the floor, but just couldn't quite connect.
Noah Blackwell bounces for Levin. Levin gets by Jones, falls away, off the mark. Good box out there by Jermaine Haley, saves it to Endier. Aggies trying to run more this year. They've missed 6 of their previous 8 shots. And now Endier misfires. Bibbins bounces out. Blackwell can shoot it from the arc, and he makes the 3. The Beach red hot from 3.
Well, as good as the Aggies are, Adam, they don't have a true point guard, and Bibbins may expose that tonight. He's lightning quick.
Long Beach State 3 of 6 on trays. NM State 2 of 3. A foul called there on Long Beach State and LaRod Williams, a redshirt freshman from Long Beach. Dan Munson plays a fair amount of guys as well. We see Temadio Youssef come back in for Williams. That's number 2 on LaRod Williams, so he'll sit for a while. And if you play for Paul Weir, you're probably going to get about 2 or 3 minutes in a stretch before you get taken out. So you go hard in those 2 or 3 minutes.
Yes. I think that's precisely what he has in mind.
Sidi Endier having a great sophomore year, averaging a team-high 13 points per game. Ball reversal in the arc for Huggins. He shot it well this year. And he throws it behind Endier. Endier was running the baseline, and Huggins threw it behind him. This is kind of like the start that the Aggies got off to on Wednesday. They really picked it up in half two, scoring 51 points in that half, getting back in the game against Air Force. Stolen by Jones, but he can't save it on the baseline. He's so active, Russ, defensively. I mean, his arms are everywhere. Sure, he's only 6'5", but he does have a nice wingspan on it.
He's boundless. And don't give him any coffee, Adam. He's just wired up.
And that goes to the Aggies off the hands of sophomore Noah Blackwell. NM State 3 of 10 from the floor. A little stagnant here, Coach, you think? Baker all the way to the rim. Can't flip it through. There's not a whole lot of movement right now offensively.
No, there's a little too much standing around, I'd say.
Cutting is Levin. Can't finish. Right there, Youssef, and he can't stick it back in. Cleared away again by Eli Chua.
Well, Aggie's got a break there.
In transition, Baker bumped on his way to the rim. We're going to wave off the hoop. And it's going to be on the ground.
I think part of what's going on, Adam, is I think this Long Beach team is pretty tough defensively. And they're helped very well, and they're very stingy and stubborn defensively. And the Aggies just cannot get an easy shot.
Numbers-wise, it just doesn't show. They're allowing 86 per game, but when you're going to Louisville, going to North Carolina, going to Kansas.
Yes, you can almost throw those out.
Exactly. Yeah.
And if you think tonight, that one of the Aggies, they've got 9 points, but three of them were just sort of a desperation three by Chua as the shot clock wound down. This is a stingy ball club defensively.
Baker can't end the scoreless drought. It's over 2 minutes now for the Aggies. And they trail by six here at home. Paul Weir trying different combinations. Garza is going to check in next at ball. Lauren Jackson, the freshman point guard, bounces for Youssef, swirls out for him. Youssef dives, tries to throw it off the leg of Endier, and the Aggies have a 5-on-4. Youssef is trailing. Huggins triggers, and that's no good. Jamario Jones flips it home.
Well, that's one thing that makes your offense look better, as we talked about before the game.
Timeout call by Long Beach, and we'll take it with them. The garbage points there for Jamario Jones. Transfer in from Hill JUCO in Hillsboro, Texas. He's one of those JUCO transfers playing a role for the Aggies. And they're within 4.5-1.
Ms. Rodriguez, we noticed some unusual account activity. Did you make an $810 purchase at Urban Cycling?
Yep, that was me. Thanks for checking.
Hey, sweet, a bike. Are you thinking of training?
Nah, I'm thinking of riding to work. You know, a little alone time.
We're not breaking up a carpool, right?
I'm just messing with you guys.
24/7 fraud monitoring, security, convenience, together.
Seriously, what's a bike for?
Wells Fargo, together we'll go far.
If I lose, I'll respond with respect.
If I win, I'll back it up with humility.
If I fail, I'll rise up with honor. It's tough for us to put it all on the line.
Don't undo my hard work with poor sportsmanship.
Respect, it's the name of the game.
Buying a home? Don't forget to check the low-rate mortgage options offered by White Sands Federal Credit Union. White Sands Federal Credit Union. The difference is black and white. A home improvement loan from White Sands Federal Credit Union can help you make your home the best it can be. Unfortunately, we can't help you clean up. White Sands Federal Credit Union. The difference is black and white.
New Mexico State basketball on Aggie Vision is presented by Pepsi, White Sands Federal Credit Union, Route 66, Memorial Medical, and by Wells Fargo.
A Pennham State only shooting 29% from the field, but they're within four here on top of Lou Henson Court, looking to go to 6-0 at home on the campaign. Here's a look at the Paul Weir file. Paul Weir, the first-year head coach at New Mexico State, 9 years as an assistant coach. And as they say, Coach Bradbury, it's only one seat over on the bench, and that's a big step for somebody, especially a young guy like Paul Weir, and he's taking it well.
They say it's the longest 24 inches in the world. But he's calm and collected. He's not a holler scream guy. And you know, Marvin Menzies wasn't either. The players liked and respected both of these guys, and I think it'll work in their favor, work in Paul's favor especially.
A little bit of a scoring drought here for Long Beach State as well. Neither offense playing great. There's Barry Ogilew, who scored 9 points in just 9 minutes last game at Kansas.
Well, that's the second time the Aggies have been beat backdoor in the sort of deceptive play where they think the screen and roll's coming and the wing just dips backdoor.
A lot of minutes here for Garza. Jones, not really a three-point shooter, fades, hits the top side of the backboard, and here comes Noah Blackwell on the beach. That's the thing about Jamario Jones' game that probably hampers him a little bit, is he doesn't have that range with his jump shot. He needs to be around 15 feet or in. Blackwell, a long two.
Whereas Noah Blackwell can shoot a little further out.
He'll shoot wherever. 6 points per game last year, 6 this year as well.
Yeah, I'm going to go on record here, Adam, and say I'm worried. I think these guys are this, they're not at all intimidated. They've been to Kansas. They've been to UCLA. They've been to North Carolina.
And they're hungry for a win, too.
Yes.
They're 1-8. 8 on the shot clock. Hand off to Huggins. Brings in the three right over Noah Blackwell. Six of the Aggies, 14 from Huggins, aren't too many threes. This is Lauren Jackson. Same body type as Justin Bibbins. Jackson only a freshman. He's from Chicago. Played a prep ball, though, in Bradenton, Florida. Ogilew hits by Garza. Dumps it off to Mason Riggins, who fights up. Can't score. It'll get free throws. He's a big body. Mason Riggins, 6'8", 255. He's a sophomore out of White, Wright, Texas. And, Coach, he started 23 games last year, and it's been a little more limited action for him this year.
Well, that's what scares me about this Long Beach team is there's hardly a, other than Lauren Jackson, there's hardly a rookie. And Lauren Jackson, his father, is a well-known Chicago high school coach. So this is a kid who grew up around the game. This is a very seasoned team. I think this is the team that will win the Big West. I'll just say that right now. But as we've talked about over and over again, you certainly wouldn't know it by their record up to this point.
Now, if you watched Mason Riggins shoot free throws, you would not believe that he's a 35% career foul shooter. It looks pretty good. The stroke isn't too bad. He banks it in. He gets bowed, but it looks okay, right? Follow through, left hand going straight up.
That was right on cue, Adam. You must have worked that out with him before the game.
That'll improve his percentage. He is now 7 of 19 this season from the charity line. Fading, Chua catches, slings a pass intended for Wilkins, and it rolls out of bounds.
It's just excellent help by Long Beach State. There's no easy shot.
You can tweet at us. Let us know where you're watching from tonight at NMSU Aggie Vision. At NMSU Aggie Vision is our Twitter handle. Let us know where you're watching from and which station you're watching on. Foul called on Riggins there on the high hedge for Long Beach. That is number 7, Coach Bradbird, on Long Beach State. Only 1 on the Aggies. So bonus free throws for an 83% foul shooter, Ian Baker.
Well, Baker's, you know, he's ice water in the veins. He's sort of expressionless on the court. He's always cool and calm.
He's really grown, too. He played a little bit as a freshman, but his role's been bigger each season, and now he's the go-to guy for the Aggies as the lone senior.
That's right, Dan. He's not a true point guard. He's just a good all-around player who can score a lot of different ways. And he's not banking in his free throws. Aggies keep staying in the press. They clearly, I think they want to try and hope to wear out the Long Beach team that's up their frequent flyer miles this year.
15,000 miles plus of travel here in this 9-game road swing for Long Beach State. 11 catches, 25 feet away. Ogilvie was open, but Riggins could not find him. There's Jackson underneath, finds Blackwell. Long on the three, offensive board, Riggins. And they'll reset with Levin, and now Jackson. Levin, the Loyola Marymount transfer, swishes in the jumper. That's where he wants to be, about 15, 18 feet into his hay right there. And M State trailing by 7. Jonathan Wilkins with that range from the elbow.
Well, what concerns me at this point, Adam, not that it's any of my business, I'm not the coach, but they do seem to be relying on the jump shot quite a bit. I mean, every time Maggie score, it's a jump shot. And I think they're going to have to establish a little bit of a post game at some point. Of course, you know, they're often playing three guards and sometimes four guards.
Foul called on Wilkins as Levin took it towards the rim. He passed up that three, but he's attempted 23 three-pointers this year. Levin at 6'7", can shoot it from the perimeter. Wholesale subs here for 10th year head coach Dan Munson and the 49ers. Number 23 in gold right there is Roshan Prince. He's a USC transfer, one of three Division I transfers for Long Beach State. Jackson triggers in to Jordan Griffin. He's only a freshman. Griffin spinning on Taylor. Backdoor right for Williams. Underneath, Roshan Prince.
Well, two Aggies just a little bit late there. They had the right idea, but just couldn't quite get there in time.
Long Beach State is shooting 53% from the field. Eli Chua fires from three. That's way long. Backside board there for Javonte Jackson. 7-point advantage for the 49ers. Bibbins, he found LaRon Williams for the slam. Great feed by Justin Bibbins. And Long Beach State has their biggest lead here tonight. The 49ers looking for their first road win of the campaign. Looking for their first win against a Division I of the campaign. And they're playing well in Las Cruces. It's 27-18. The 49ers have the lead.
Notice how life's little mishaps never happen at a convenient time? The new Memorial Urgent Care at Sonoma is built around real families. Whether it's a fever, stitches, or dad's weekend project gone wrong, our friendly medical team at Memorial Urgent Care has you covered when it just can't wait. Open 7 days a week from 9 a.m. to 8 p.m. Memorial Urgent Care, priced right and conveniently located on the corner of Sonoma Ranch and Highway 70.
Like road signs, my words are true. They bring me slowly back.
I missed you.
Did you bring new ones?
You work hard for more than just you.
You went to Montana.
I did.
Working together, we'll help you save for her future geology degree. Wells Fargo. Together we'll go far.
According to the latest edition of the Hispanic Outlook for Higher Education Top 100 Colleges and Universities for Hispanics list, NM State has been listed as one of the best. NM State ranks 26th in bachelor's degrees awarded and 21st in master's degrees. For more information, visit nmsu.edu. Adam Young with former NM State assistant coach Russ Bradford, Lou Henson Court, Pan American Center. NM State 5-0 in this building this year. They are 70-6 in their previous 76 home games. This has been a really tough place for opponents to play. There's Ian Baker Coach, I would assume he's the guy that really needs to get this offense jump started, right?
I think that's right. And it's, you know, the Aggies are very guard oriented this year, and they've got three guards in the game right now. And if they're up against a veteran crew with Bibbins and this Long Beach State crew. I think looks like Long Beach is going to come into a zone here and see if they can, even though they're up nine, they're going to try and change up a little bit here. Interesting move by Dan Munson.
This is where Jamario Jones is really, really good at the head of that zone in the high post area. Haley on the baseline, Chua, high arcing jumper in for Eli Chua. In fact, Paul Weir told me, it was about a week or two ago, whenever a team goes to a zone, if Jamario Jones isn't in, usually Paul puts him in. San Diego did that a few games ago, and once they went to the zone, Jamario Jones came in and he made an impact there on the high post area.
And it's because he can slash, and not because he's bombing in three-pointers, mm-hmm. but because he slashes and attacks the basket. And I just want to know what Paul Weir told you. I thought I got all the inside scoops from Paul Weir.
And I do a little bit of radio. That's
no,
where I get it.
Well, he's an interesting player, Jamario.
Javonte Jackson off balance. Jermaine Haley nearly tipped it in for Long Beach State. It was picked up by Griffin. Another offensive rebound. Griffin misses twice from the same spot. Snatched in by Jones. Post feed batted away. Jamario leans in, and he floats it in. Jamario Jones, red hot for the Aggies. Jones has seven. Roshan Prince muscles it up, left it short. Great verticality there by Eli Chua. Baker slithers down low. No call. Ian was looking for a foul right there. Bibbins transition triple, an air ball. Maybe a little ill-advised there for the junior point guard who looks to his bench and says, my bad, to Dan Munson. Great to have Tyce Foster watching tonight from Lubbock, Texas. Emil Matthews is watching from Artesia. You can tweet at us at NMSU Aggievision. Let us know where you're watching from and also what station you are watching on tonight. Glad you could join us. 27-22, the Beach over the Aggies so far.
Well, Long Beach back, they didn't stay in the zone very long.
That just can't happen if you're Roshan Prince. A foul with the Aggies and the bonus well away from the hoop. Trying to hedge a screen, and Ian Baker, his nearly automatic, will get one in the bonus right here. NM State has picked it up from the field. They have made four of their previous five shots. They're now shooting 40%. One of the things the coaches said leading up to the season why Ian Baker was a potential draft prospect, and he's coming off of somewhere where he tested the NBA draft waters. They said he shoots it at an NBA level. That's what the scouts were saying, that the draft gurus. So we'll see if he has a chance after his senior year to play at the next level in the NBA. There's a few Aggies in the NBA right now. Pascal Siakam and Jonathan Gibson.
Yeah, I'm the wrong guy to ask. I never thought Jonathan Gibson would make it. And he's a 29-year-old rookie with the Dallas Mavericks.
And nobody really expected Pascal to be a first rounder. It's a one possession game. Five to shoot. Handoff goes to Jordan Griffin. Slipping is Youssef. And a foul underneath. I think it's Arjamario. Yeah, it's Arjamario Jones. And that's his first. Team's fifth.
See, the Aggies are going to be in trouble if Long Beach is catching the ball there. It's going to be a long night.
Long to Bibbins. Swirls in for Justin Bibbins. And he has eight. He only averages nine for the season. Baker blocking the foul in, and one for Ian Baker.
Well, Baker has taken things into his own hand a little bit. Watch him, he goes in here into about three guys. Watch him go right into the teeth of the defense here. And gets the roll. He's great on the running one-handers and the sort of the floaters.
And he tried to sidestep that defender just enough to draw a blocking foul. He continues to shoot it well for the free throw line, 5 of 5 tonight. He was 83% coming in. 2-point ball game. Youssef steps out of bounds in the baseline. Great defense by Wilkins.
The fact that Youssef has struggled so much tonight, he hustles and plays hard, but he's really struggling. He can't get it in the basket, and that's part of the reason the Aggies are even in the hunt. If Youssef had been making shots around the basket, they'd be in big trouble.
NM State has Wilkins, Baker, Jamario Jones, Taylor, and Huggins on the floor. Hesitation for Jamario in the interior. Bounces out for Huggins. 10 to shoot for the Aggies. This is Matt Taylor. Wraparound pass, Wilkins, and one. Jonathan Wilkins, and we're tied at 29.
Well, now that was the first time tonight, I feel like, Adam, that the Aggies have sort of played together and showed patience instead of thinking they could just kind of do it on their own. And just a little old-fashioned pick and roll with Matt Taylor and Jonathan Wilkins. And Wilkins has been a bit of a mystery so far, hasn't he? I expected huge things from him this year, but he's slow getting out of the starting blocks. How do you say starting blocks in French?
Your guess is as good as mine.
All right. But we expected great. He's a wonderful kid, a talented left-hander, and I think we all expected big things, and maybe we still will see them this year.
Yeah, his production's been down, Coach. He averaged 6 per game last year, only 2 points per game this season, but he's coming off his best game. Scored 9 points against Air Force. Foul is called on Ian Baker. It's the first on Ian. City Endier back in for the Yankees. He's really improved. There's a number of guys who have improved their production a ton, but nobody more than City, who barely saw minutes last year. 13 points per game to lead the Yankees this season. Bibbins is quick. Long jumper, Jackson. High rebound, Braxton Huggins. And a foul is called on Long Beach State. So Huggins will go to the free throw line. The Aggies have attempted 8 free throws already, only 2 attempts for Long Beach State.
Well, watch this swarming defense by the Aggies. You can feel the momentum shifting a little bit. The Aggies are much more active. Look at, Huggins is only 6'3 or 6'4 going up in the crowd there to grab that one.
Huggins, a team best 84% from the free throw line. Boy, was he a good high school scorer in California. He's out of Bakersfield, which is in the Aggies Conference. He went to Miramonte High School, 32 per game his senior year. So Paul Weir and his staff, they knew he could fill it up, but he hadn't really shown that until this season.
I think that's one of Paul Weir's many strengths. I think he's a shrewd evaluator of talent.
3-point lead for the Aggies and a blocking foul at the midcourt line are Jamario Jones, and that's going to be his second. He's had a couple of cheap ones, a couple of reach-ins on Jamario.
Well, it's risky to try and pressure Bibbins that far from the basket as quicky as he is. Have the Aggies played a better point guard this year than Justin Bibbins?
I don't think so.
Yeah, I don't think so either.
I don't think so.
And again, he hasn't shot well yet this year, but that's against North Carolina and Louisville and UCLA and people like that. And we haven't seen Evan Payne yet, who I guess is hurt.
And he's coming off an ankle injury. Did not play against Kansas. That was in the cylinder. And that is going to be goaltending. It will not count.
Well, I think that would have gone in if they hadn't hit it.
This has been a 14-2 run for the Aggies over the previous 3 minutes and 21 seconds. And the Aggies have taken the lead in Las Cruces, 32-29, NM State by 3.
Finance your car with White Sands Federal Credit Union, and you don't have to make the first payment for 90 days. White Sands Federal Credit Union. The difference is black and white. Skip a payment twice a year with any auto or personal loan from White Sands Federal Credit Union. White Sands Federal Credit Union. The difference is black and white.
Good sportsmanship isn't defined by a scoreboard.
It isn't defined by how high you can jump or how fast you can run.
Good sportsmanship is all about character.
It is about doing your best for your coaches and teammates.
It's about having respect for your opponents, the officials, and the fans.
Good sportsmanship is winning with class and losing with dignity.
It is fair play, perseverance, and team spirit.
Good sportsmanship is what unites us.
We are the Western Athletic Hawks.
Hello, Totten Designs. A sales department? Yes, I can put you right through. Sales department, this is Nate.
Human resources.
Technical support.
Hold, please.
You work hard to grow your business.
Yes. I can totally do that for you.
Working together, we can help your business thrive. Wells Fargo. Together we'll go far.
There's New Mexico State's women's basketball team. A big win for them earlier this week against rival New Mexico on Wednesday. They're going to have Arizona in this building tomorrow. It is a 1 p.m. start tomorrow afternoon. Arizona from the Pac-12 will be on top of Lou Henson Court. 32-29, the Aggies lead by three. We'll get a replay here of this goaltending call. I'm with you, Coach.
I think it was going to drop in for Levin. Gabe Levin's got to be shaking his head thinking that took away his basket. But yeah, the Aggies have gotten some good breaks, and the momentum has shifted quite a bit here.
Eight for Bibbins to lead Dan Munson's team. Eight for Huggins to lead Paul Weir's team. Aggies have Chua, Huggins, Endear, Taylor, and Penny. Bibbins, Blackwell, Williams, Javante Jackson, and Levin for Long Beach State. This is the biggest lead all evening here for the Aggies. Long Beach State led by as many as nine earlier. City Endear can't connect. And it's going to go to Long Beach State. I think that's the right call there for our official, Ruben Ramos.
And that interesting move by Dan Munson. He's bringing in, he's got two guards at about 5'7" here.
Yeah, I saw this in some of their previous games. They're willing to play Jackson and Bibbins together. And like you said, 5'7" to 5'8". They're listed 5'8", but maybe closer to 5'7". So this is a really small, especially defensive lineup for Long Beach State with Jackson and Bibbins on the floor. Jackson bounces for Bibbins, who gets a ball screen from Williams. Bibbins looking for his third made three, barely grazed the rim. And the crowd will scream air ball. Got a piece of the rim there.
Well, it's the first time since tonight he's looked bad. He's had a terrific game up to this point.
UNM State on an 8-0 run. Scoring drought of 2:14 for the Beach. UNM State trying to stay patient. Huggins inside the perimeter. Jalen Penny heaves a three. Pinballs out. Chua, the only white jersey down there. No rebounders there for the Aggies. Three gold jerseys. Lauren Jackson from three. That's a brick. Offensive board, though, for Javante Jackson.
Well, the Aggies have a chance to make their move here if they can keep the intensity up.
LaRon Williams was pushed in the back on his cut. That's going to be number six on the Aggies.
Well, it's supposed to be a point of emphasis this year, I guess, Adam. We talked about it at lunch the other day, where you're not supposed to ride a guy with the forearm in the back as he comes through the lane. It's supposed to be more of a finesse game now.
That's going to be number seven, actually. Number seven on the Aggies, so bonus free throws for LaRon Williams. Only one senior for Long Beach. Numerous freshmen have played a big role this year, including Williams, who's a redshirt freshman. One of two Long Beach natives for the 49ers this year. And he's now 12 of 17 on free throw tries. Williams only averaging 2 points per game. This has to be an exciting schedule for Long Beach State, playing so many premier programs and get to see the country. I know it's been grueling, and you like to get a win or two against North Carolina or Louisville, but.
Well, everything seems easy after the preseason, I would imagine.
This isn't new. They've done this for a while now. Endear all the way to the rack. In fact, Long Beach State in the last seven seasons. They've ranked no lower than sixth in the country in non-conference strength of schedule. So this has kind of been the MO for Dan Monson during his tenure. Double high ball screen for Bibbins, and he's hit by Wilkins. And Paul Weir does not agree with Ruben Ramos. One of the neat things about being a head coach is you get to speak to the officials more. It's one of the positives or the negatives, I guess.
I don't know. There's other people I'd rather talk to. You, for example, Adam.
Yeah. Bibbins, an 82% career free throw shooter. He's out of Carson, California, scored 14 points and dished out 8 assists against the Aggies last season in this meeting. I'm with you, Russ. I don't think the Aggies have played a point guard of his caliber yet. Maybe in the future, but not yet. He's awfully good. 34-33. A pretty high scoring first half, as it's turned out. Low scoring early. Aggies have heated up at 44% now from the field. They weave on the arc. Taylor gets the defender Ogulu in the air. Only six on the shot clock, 90 seconds for the half. Great look for Endier. City Endier rattles in the three.
Well, now that was a really good sign, I thought, Adam. Things were a little bit out of sync there, but the Aggies showed great patience and wound down the shot clock. That was maybe the best series the Aggies have had. Not that it was wound up with a layup, but they just showed great patience and willingness to play together.
Nibbins looking to pass here, stolen away. Endier trying to stay on his feet, and he's hit. He's hit by Bibbins. And that will be number two on the one player they can't lose.
That's
Justin
right.
Bibbins.
Well, with Evan Payne out, with Evan Payne hurt, you know, who was 17 a game at Loyola Marymount a few years ago. Aggies got, I think, you know, City was about to lose that one anyway. There's a Sinke Carey, the assistant coach that used to play for the Lobos. Let's not welcome any Lobos. In fact, why am I even bringing that up? Forget I said that about any Lobos.
One of Dan Munson's longtime assistants actually went with Marvin Menzies to UNLV. Eric Brown, he's on Marvin Menzies' staff now. He was with Dan Munson for, I think, 9 years. Double bonus free throws for City. He made the first one. All the way from France, a redshirt sophomore. Beautiful looking stroke. Lead is six. The Aggies continuing to shoot well from the free throw line. Too good of a look there for Noah Blackwell. Way too open. City attacking. Hit again. Right back to the free throw line for two more.
Well, I love City's game, but he needs to either put that mouthpiece in his mouth or take it out. It's not a toy. But here, watch him. He's just really, really slippery when he slashes to the basket. Really smart the way he can sort of attack things. He's limping a little bit.
The first thing I thought of when I watched him play last season was he's smooth. And maybe it's just a left-hander in him that makes him look smooth, but everything comes so natural to him. Kind of effortless with City Endier's game, especially offensively.
I know I'm obsessing about his mouthpiece. Could he either get that? Either does he get it in or take it out. He'll actually hurt himself if he gets hit in the mouth with his mouthpiece like that.
Need something to chew on, Coach. Shooting well from the free throw line. The Aggies are 13 of 14 out. Ogulu had a shot, passed it up. Prince bounces for Blackwell. The Aggies all over him now. Bibbins on the bench with two, so this is Jackson running the point. Ogulu, deep two in the corner. Rebound weak side, Taylor. Paul Weir is trying to call for one shot. There's about a 2 second difference. Game clock, shot clock here. NM State has made six of their previous eight shots. Trying to finish off the half here on a high note. Endier has 9 points. Ball screen from Boulard, who just came in. Four on the shot clock. Huggins on the wing. Gets the defender in the air. Fades. Can't make it. Boulard, the offensive board, then out of his hands. And a three-quarter court heave from Jackson. His way off the mark. A pretty good finish, though, for the Aggies at the end of half one, and it spread out again with their scoring attack. 9 for Endier to lead all Aggie scores, 8 for Huggins, 7 each for Jamario Jones and Ian Baker, 5 each for Jonathan Wilkins and Eli Chua. Long Beach State finishes the first half, missing 11 of their final 13 shots. Halftime score, Aggies 41, 49ers 36.
We strive to achieve excellence through determination and hard work.
We are committed to learning from those around us,
our professors and peers,
our coaches and teammates,
and our opponents.
We compete with integrity and passion.
And we seize our moment when the opportunity arises.
We take pride in our communities.
And believe that we can inspire others
just as they can inspire us.
We may wear different colors, but we share the same purpose.
We learn, we compete, we inspire.
We are the Western Athletic Conference.
And here we have 1893 from the makers of Pepsi Cola. I'm gonna swirl it. I'm gonna smell it. I'm just gonna take one small sip.
Kinda seemed like more than a sip.
Yeah, let me show you. Refined.
1893, made with cola nut extract and real sugar. Boldly blended colas.
For Vegas-style action, play the hottest table games now at the casino at Sunland Park. Go all in for a great time with exciting electronic blackjack and stay, hit, or play your way to winning big. Or place your bets on electronic roulette, where a jackpot could be yours with any spin of the wheel. Vegas-style action, baby, you bet. Let your hot streak begin. The casino at Sunland Park, I-10 to Sunland Park, exit 13.
Play responsibly. Helpline 1-800-572-1142.
Introducing a more pleasurable way to buy a car. Get a low-rate auto loan from White Sands Federal Credit Union, even before you walk on the lot. White Sands Federal Credit Union, the difference is black and white. Introducing First Checking, a free checking account for kids between 13 and 17 years old. A First Checking account can help you teach your kids financial literacy. White Sands Federal Credit Union, the difference is black and white.
NM State has a 41-36 advantage against Long Beach State here tonight. The Aggies looking for their fifth straight win, also trying to go to 6-0 at home on the campaign. After tonight's game, log on to nmstatesports.com for a full recap of tonight's game. Also, stats and scores from all of your favorite Aggie sports. nmstatesports.com. It is your home for New Mexico State athletics. This past Tuesday was Giving Tuesday, and we would like to thank everyone who made a donation to better the lives of NM State students. Aggie Vision attended the Giving Tuesday celebration ceremony, and you can find out just how much money was raised in donations.
Tuesday, November 29th, was a busy day at New Mexico State. It was the second annual Giving Tuesday event, and it started bright and early.
We did a kickoff celebration at 9 a.m. and celebrated all the donors who had given throughout the night. We opened at midnight online and continued to give and celebrated all those donors at our kickoff.
Those donors came from across the state and the entire country to give back to the university, the programs, and the student scholarships they love the most.
And I want to tell you an interesting story. I was standing back there a little earlier in the day, and a young man walked up to me. He's probably 28 years old. And he said, "President Carruthers," yes, and he gave me his name. He said, "About 8 years ago, I came to see you because I needed money to stay in school. And you found money for me to stay in school, and I'm here to give back." We helped them, they're giving back.
By the end of business day on Tuesday, they had raised over $1.9 million.
I heard about one of our friends in Dallas just matched $10,000. We've had a couple of big donations, $35,000, $50,000 donations from outside of our local community. It's really been terrific. The biggest gift I know of is $250,000 challenge grant by the Devastalis for the new art building. That's an amazing amount of money for these people to give in support of our facilities and our students at New Mexico State.
this building has the potential to be the jewel in the crown for NMSU. And so let's get this across that finish line. So thank you very much, and go Aggies.
Thank you to all of our advancement marketing communications team, as well as our volunteers. We had volunteers across our campus from our business community. We had people from around the state drive in to support us. It was just an amazing day. We had the chancellor, our athletic director, our coaches, our staff making thank you calls. I want to thank every single person who contributed through their time, volunteerism, and who made this day possible.
For Aggie Vision, I'm Vinny Conway.
6 players for the Aggies with 5 points or more, led by Endier's 9. Halftime stats and highlights after this.
On the field,
in the pool,
on the court,
we wear our game faces under the lights.
But sometimes our toughest opponents aren't wearing a uniform.
Instead, we confront them internally.
Mental illness affects 1 in 4 adults in the United States.
Suicide is the second leading cause of death among college students.
If you or someone you know is fighting a silent battle, please speak up and ask for help.
You are not alone.
Wells Fargo is making changes to make things right. First, all customers who have been impacted will be fully refunded. Second, a confirmation will be sent when new personal or small business checking, savings, or credit card accounts are opened. Third, we've eliminated product sales goals for our retail bankers to ensure your interests are put first. We're taking action. We're renewing our commitment to you.
Halftime score is NM State 41 and Long Beach State 36. The 49ers trying to snap an 8-game losing streak and also pick up their first Division I win of the year. Be sure to find NM State Athletics and Aggie Vision on all social media. You can like NM State Aggies on Facebook and also follow the Aggies on Twitter at NM State Aggies. You can also subscribe to Aggie Vision's YouTube channel for highlights, interviews, and other weekly videos. Glad you could join us here tonight alongside former NM State assistant coach Russ Bradford, Adam Young on hand. The Aggies didn't play great in the first 10 minutes, coach, but much better in the final 10 of that first half.
Yeah, what we saw early was Long Beach State shooting layup after layup and missing quite a few easy shots, too, or the Aggies could have really been in trouble. But as the game progressed, the Aggies seemed to wake up and played real team ball, really shared the ball and got much better shots as the game went on.
Let's take a look at the first half highlights. You mentioned, coach, that early on in the game, the Aggies were settling for maybe too many jump shots. Got some layups later. Here we're going to see an Eli Chua made 3. The Aggies attempted 10 threes, but easier looks later on in the half, you think?
That's right. And I do think that Long Beach State is a little bit road weary because they're plenty quick. And they're a smart team. But the Aggies came as the half went on. The Aggies shared the ball a little bit better. Not that they were selfish, but they just looked a little bit out of sync in the early stages of the game.
That was the second made 3 for Justin Bibbins. Bibbins in that first half with 10 points to pace Long Beach State, but he's currently in foul trouble with 2 personals. Speaking of foul trouble, Jamario Jones also has 2 personals, but he was great when he was in, scoring 7 points and grabbing 5 rebounds for the Aggies. This is Bibbins again, does so many things well. Here he finds LaRon Williams for a deuce for Long Beach State. They led by as many as 9 in the first 20 minutes of action. Then the Aggie offense started to get going. A couple of and ones. First it was Ian Baker, then right there, Jonathan Wilkins. Wilkins had 5 points in 9 minutes off the Aggie bench. Noah Blackwell got a couple of clean looks. He made 2 threes on 3 three-point tries. Long Beach State, 4 of 11. And there is one of the 4 Aggie threes. City Endear, who's leading the Aggies with 9, knocks one home late in the first half. The Aggie lead is 41-36. First half stats on the other side of this break.
Ms. Rodriguez, we noticed some unusual account activity. Did you make an $810 purchase at Urban Cycling?
Yep, that was me. Thanks for checking.
Hey, sweet, a bike. Are you thinking of training?
Nah, I'm thinking of riding to work. You know, a little alone time.
We're not breaking up a carpool, right?
I'm just messing with you guys.
24/7 fraud monitoring, security, convenience, together.
Seriously, what's a bike for?
Wells Fargo, together we'll go far.
If I lose, I'll respond with respect.
If I win, I'll back it up with humility.
If I fail, I'll rise up with honor. It's tough for us to put it all on the line.
Don't undo my hard work with poor sportsmanship.
Respect. It's the name of the game.
Buying a home? Don't forget to check the low-rate mortgage options offered by White Sands Federal Credit Union. White Sands Federal Credit Union. The difference is black and white. A home improvement loan from White Sands Federal Credit Union can help you make your home the best it can be. Unfortunately, we can't help you clean up. White Sands Federal Credit Union. The difference is black and white.
Notice how life's little mishaps never happen at a convenient time? The new Memorial Urgent Care at Sonoma is built around real families. Whether it's a fever, stitches, or dad's weekend project gone wrong, our friendly medical team at Memorial Urgent Care has you covered when it just can't wait. Open 7 days a week from 9 a.m. to 8 p.m. Memorial Urgent Care, priced right and conveniently located on the corner of Sonoma Ranch and Highway 70.
Like road signs, my words are true. They bring me slowly back.
I missed you.
Did you bring new ones?
You work hard for more than just you.
You went to Montana.
I did.
Working together, we'll help you save for her future geology degree. Wells Fargo. Together we'll go far.
Tonight's game on Aggie Vision is brought to you by Route 66, Wells Fargo, Pepsi, Memorial Medical, and by White Sands Federal Credit Union.
A good crowd here tonight at the Pan American Center where the Aggies are trying to win at home again. The Aggies are 5-0 in home games this year. They have won 70 of their previous 76 home games. Tickets to see the Aggie men's basketball program are on sale now. For more information or to purchase, call the Pan American Center ticket office, 575-646-1420. You can also go online to Ticketmaster.com. Well, the Aggies shot better in the later stages of that first half, Russ. They eventually shot 44% from the field and really did a good job, and so did Long Beach State at the charity stripe.
That's right, slashing to the basket and showed better patience. And I do think Long Beach has gotten worn out a little bit from all this traveling that they've done. But it should be a terrific second half, Adam.
Sidy Endier has paced the Aggies so far. He has 9 points, 2 of 5 shooting, 1 of 3 from three. And Sidy is perfect from the free throw line. We'll see how the two personals will play a role early on in the second half with Justin Bibbins. He was great when he was in, but he picked up his second foul late in that first half. Well, the Aggies lead by 5, Coach. How have they done so far in your keys to the game?
Well, I don't know. I do think that they came out. I don't know if they thought this would be easy or not, but they appeared to think it would be easy in the beginning, but they've bounced back quickly. It is no day at the beach here. This is going to be a tough battle. They've struggled containing Justin Bibbins up to this point. He's been a dominant force out there. And they have not done a great job, their usual great job of offensive rebounds. They only have 4 offensive rebounds. Nothing makes the offense look better than just grab it and stick it back in. So this is really a terrific matchup. The Big West champion, favorite champion, and the New Mexico State Aggies should be a terrific second half.
Yeah, really a nice opponent here for the Aggies with the Big West preseason favorite in town. By the way, some other schools in the Big West, you have UC Davis, they could contend. UC Irvine, they're going to be in Las Cruces playing the Aggies in a few weeks. They'll certainly contend, they do every year. And Hawaii is typically good as well in that Big West conference. Dan Munson trying to take his program back to the NCAA tournament. They've only had 2 NCAA tourney trips since 1995. One came in 07, the other was in 2012. They had a good player a few years ago, a transfer named Casper Ware. Did a good job for Dan Munson just a few years back. They won 20 games last season, 1-8 this year. Aggies trying to extend their lead here in their first possession in half two. Eli Chua calls for it. And he gets called for traveling. You worry about the size that the Aggies play with sometimes down the road in the WAC, because you look right now, it's a 4-guard lineup. Jalen Penny's got some length as a guard, but it's a 4-guard lineup with just Eli Chua there in the front court.
Well, I think like all of us, Paul Weir's waiting for Tanvir Bular to come around.
He's 11 short on his 3, and it's going to stay with the 49ers.
And we haven't even talked about Marlon Jones, you know, Marlon Pookie Jones, who has a huge reputation in Chicago, and I think Paul Weir expected big things, but he's been nagged by little injuries up to this point, and he hasn't really got on track the South Plains Junior College transfer.
This is 6 straight games now for Marlon Jones not seeing action. He's out in street clothes with an injury. Went to Orr High School in Chicago. Youssef. He looked at Jackson, who was posting up smaller player Huggins. Jumper good for the freshman Jordan Griffin. One of the things Paul Weir was talking about after the Air Force win with Tanvir Bular is some days he just can't play because of the style that's being played. Huggins nails a 3. Sometimes there just really isn't a matchup for Tanvir at 7-2. Griffin again, that's an air ball, handled by Jamario Jones. Aggies trying to push when they can. Huggins long, Jamario the offensive rebound.
Well, that's where he really can really help the Aggies is, you know, Huggins shot that one pretty quick. Wasn't a great shot, wasn't a terrible shot, but Jamario Jones bails him out by grabbing the offensive rebound. Doesn't stick it back in, but just gives the Aggies another chance. And that kind of aggression and that kind of nose for the ball is just really invaluable.
Sidy Endier with it for NM State. Bounces for Huggins on the wing. Here's Jamario Jones. They're going to sag off and let him shoot a jump shot. Runs over Levin, and that's the 3rd on Jamario. And that right there is where not having a deep jump shot really comes into play.
Yes.
Levin was forcing him to shoot it.
And maybe a little inexperienced, too. He's, as we've talked about, he's sort of a player without a position. And when he catches it at 17 feet, he's a little out of his element.
Levin connects on a three. His ninth made three this year. He's shooting 35%.
And also Jamario Jones is inexperienced there, leaving their best player. Probably an ill-advised time to help.
Eli Chu at the left hand. Long, lanky sophomore out of Redlands, California. 2.5 in, half two. The Aggies lead by 5 points, 46-41. Griffin, great feed. Bibbins underneath for Javonte Jackson.
What's the third or fourth time this game that Long Beach has backdoored the Aggies and left them sort of looking a little bit lost?
Jamario spins, fakes, and finishes. How about that deep move there by Jamario Jones?
Well, I think if he could just kind of get his experience and get kind of comfortable, here's what I can do and here's what I better not do. He's going to be a great contributor this year.
Traveling on Bibbins. And Jamario, too, in the previous play, had to be careful because he's playing with three. He's got three fouls, so he had to make sure he didn't run over the defender.
That's right, and I think one of the things, I'm coming to terms with this myself, Adam. I'm going to think out loud here. I think the Aggies are going to have to get used to the idea of they're going to have to take the good with the bad with Jamario Jones just because he's so hyperactive and aggressive. He's going to make some mistakes. He might get a bad foul or a turnover, that kind of thing, but he makes so many good things happen.
He's in a Memphis, Tennessee, a junior. Slips the ball screen. Huggins fouled on his way to the hoop, so Long Beach State fouling a ton again, just like they did in the first 20 minutes. Wilkins can shoot it from three. Not looking towards the cylinder, though. Great split there by Huggins, splitting defenders. The putback is blocked away. Jones reaching high, trying to finish, could not. Bounce in the corner, Griffin's three. Swirls out, good box out to Mario Jones. Saved by Levin off Jones. I'm going to say Levin, though, is out of bounds. And Dan Munson. He has a little bit of an argument. He's trying to say that it should be Long Beach ball. And he's heated, as you see him right there. And now a foul well away from the hoop on Temedayo Youssef, sophomore from Oakland, 6'7", 250, big body.
Well, that's maybe a half dozen times that Long Beach has picked up a foul on a simple ball screen a long way from the basket.
Wilkins applies a ball screen for Baker. Baker fakes the pass, scoops it through. Great fake by Ian. Quality pressure applied by the Aggies. Griffin rims in the jumper, though, just inside the free throw line. 15:36 left to go here in half two. And that will turn in to the media. NM State ahead by 7. Aggies playing well. I think the scoreboard's updated, though. It says 50-43 right now. I think it should be 50-45. We'll see when we come back. 15:36 left to go in half two. We're back after this.
We strive to achieve excellence through determination and hard work.
We are committed to learning from those around us,
our professors and peers,
our coaches and teammates,
and our opponents.
We compete with integrity and passion.
And we seize our moment when the opportunity arises.
We take pride in our communities
and believe that we can inspire others
just as they can inspire us.
We may wear different colors, but we share the same purpose.
We learn, we compete, we inspire.
We are
the Western Athletic Conference.
And here we have 1893 from the makers of Pepsi Cola. I'm gonna swirl it. I'm gonna smell it. I'm just gonna take one small sip.
Kinda seemed like more than a sip.
Yeah, let me show you. Refined.
1893, made with cola nut extract and real sugar. Boldly blended colas.
24 Vegas-style action. Play the hottest table games now at the casino at Sunland Park. Go all in for a great time with exciting electronic blackjack. And stay, hit, or play your way to winning big. Or place your bets on electronic roulette, where a jackpot could be yours with any spin of the wheel. Vegas-style action, baby. You bet. Let your hot streak begin. The casino at Sunland Park. I-10 to Sunland Park, exit 13. Play responsibly. Helpline 1-800-572-1142.
Aggie Vision's presentation of New Mexico State basketball is brought to you by Wells Fargo, Route 66, White Sands Federal Credit Union, Memorial Medical, and by Pepsi.
The score is 50-45, NM State by a handful. Largest lead, 7 for the Aggies. That was just moments ago. 15:36 left to go in this basketball game here tonight from the Pan American Center. And the Panamaniacs are out in full force. I know finals week is next week, but still a nice student section here tonight. Paul Weir's done a marvelous job trying to engage the students as much as possible. And for the most part, they've responded well. This is an exciting brand of basketball to watch.
I think that's absolutely true, Adam. It's really a fun team to watch. But don't they have English homework they should be doing for the English department?
Probably. Are you an easy grader?
No, I'm not an easy grader. And I'm a stickler on attendance. But, yeah, it's a really fun team to watch. And Paul's done a great job of that. Oh, we see Braxton Huggins goes down.
Huggins will get 3 free throws. He's the leading scorer now for the Aggies with 11. Only player in double figures, and he leads all scorers, too, with those 11.
Well, he's got that quick release. Watch how quickly he gets into his shot here.
You know the scatter report for Long Beach State is do not let him get a clean look. So
yes. Yeah.
If you're Williams right there, you need to get tight. And I would say make him go to the free throw line and earn those 3, but he's 84% this year.
No, that's right. It's almost automatic. Well, it's exciting to see Jonathan Wilkins contribute again. I missed all the Aggies games other than following them on the internet last year, and we all had high hopes for Jonathan Wilkins, I think. Of course, you know, and I think one of the things we haven't talked about is, you know, we lost one of the best players in Aggie history, Pascal Siakam. He made everybody better.
Hibbins, floater short, gets his own miss on the ground, ripped away though by Baker. Yeah, Siakam last year, that was 28% of the team scoring. Huggins left his 3 short. He was looking for 17 points on that 3.
But what a player Bibbins is. He gets rebounds sitting on his butt.
At 5'8", nonetheless. Williams, right-hand hook. Pinballs out to Huggins. 14 for Braxton. To the rim, floater in, 16 for Braxton Huggins.
He's feeling it here.
And Ian Baker is whistled for a foul near the end line as he fouls Bibbins.
Well, you can just see it in Bibbins' face. Now, this is a guy, this is, you know, Bibbins, as we see Ian Baker from behind Aggies, substitute a few, but Bibbins looks really frustrated, and I don't think it's just tonight so much as just he's not used to losing, and I think it doesn't sit well with him or sit well with Dan Munson for that matter.
And with their schedule, they had a couple games that they probably thought were certainly winnable, Binghamton and Florida Gulf Coast, and let those slip by, so certainly did not expect to be 1-8 here at this juncture. Taken by Jamario Jones. Good read.
I mean, yeah, he's just everywhere.
City Endier for 3. Point lead for the Aggies. Biggest lead here tonight. And they're trying to pull away from Long Beach State. A timeout is called by their head coach, Dan Munson. 14:08 left to go in half 2. The Aggies have built their largest lead here this evening. 3-point shots falling in. The Aggies ahead by 13.
Finance your car with White Sands Federal Credit Union, and you don't have to make the first payment for 90 days. White Sands Federal Credit Union. The difference is black and white. Skip a payment twice a year with any auto or personal loan from White Sands Federal Credit Union. White Sands Federal Credit Union. The difference is black and white.
Good sportsmanship isn't defined by a scoreboard.
It isn't defined by how high you can jump or how fast you can run.
Good sportsmanship is all about character.
It is about doing your best for your coaches and teammates.
It's about having respect for your opponents, the officials, and the fans.
Good sportsmanship is winning with class and losing with dignity.
It is fair play, perseverance, and team spirit.
Good sportsmanship is what unites us.
We are the Western Athletic Hawks.
Hello, Totten Designs. A sales department? Yes, I can put you right through. Sales department, this is Nate.
Human resources.
Technical support.
Hold, please.
You work hard to grow your business.
Yes. I can totally do that for you.
Working together, we can help your business thrive. Wells Fargo. Together we'll go far.
Aggie lead has grown to 13, a big three for City Endear. He's played well here tonight. NM State has now made six threes, and this was a pretty clean look here in transition, as we'll see it momentarily. The steal by Jamario Jones, and then a lead pass here by Jermaine Haley to find Endear in transition, and he gets a good look, and that is too good of a look for a great shooter like City Endear.
Well, just that, you know, we talked about it during the break, Adam, the slashing game that the Aggies have, plus being good three-point shooters, has really opened things up this half for them.
Yeah, some weapons for the Aggies with Endear and Huggins, and when you have two guys like that can make those types of shots, it helps out everybody else on the floor.
That's right. It's opened everything up, and they haven't had a great post game from anyone tonight, but the guards have been terrific.
12 for Endear, 16 for Huggins. And Dan Munson's trying to figure things out here for his team. They're in danger of falling to 1-9 on the year. They're going to be at home against Pepperdine on Wednesday, finally back home after nine straight away from Long Beach. Prince, backdoor Blackwell. And a foul is called. It's on Endear.
I want to give you one other observation, Adam. You know, you could make the argument that the Aggies would have lost without Joe Garza the other night. He just played terrific, made some big shots. And he's not playing much tonight, but when the Aggies went on their run, he's the first one running out on the court, hugging the guys and high-fiving the guys. I mean, he's all about winning.
Hey. Roshan Prince slips it through using his off left hand. Garza has only played 4 minutes in this game here tonight, but I'm right with you, Russ. And you watch him practice, he's the first guy to die for a loose ball. He's the first guy to encourage his teammates.
It's infectious. And you get two or three guys doing it, and then there's four or five guys doing it, and then no one cares who scores as long as we win. And that's, of course, Paul Weir's goal, I'm sure.
Steal for Bibbins. Speeding ahead in transition. Bounces for Jackson. And a foul is called on the Aggies. An interesting tidbit from Paul Weir post-game on Wednesday. He said, and I'm paraphrasing here, that Joe Garza, culture-wise, had just as much to do with helping out the culture of this program as Paul did. And Joe's
quite
the guy who just
say.
Came in
yes.
in the summer.
Yes, it's quite a thing to say.
And I think by that he means that wearing the New Mexico State jersey means more to Joe Garza than anybody else.
Well, you're not old enough to remember Will Benjamin as his high school coach, but that's the way Will was as a player. He was, yes, he could score, but he was just tough and great. He was fearless and team first, and I think that's all rubbed off on his Las Cruces High players.
Joe told me last week, he said, I remember going to games as a ball boy when I was a kid. I mean, growing up, he grew up in this building, and he gets a chance pretty much out of nowhere to play for the Aggies.
Well, I grew up in this building too, but in a different way.
Under Lou, right?
That's right.
Huggins is bumped. That's the fifth foul on Long Beach State. In fact, next Saturday, it's Lou Henson night. We'll see Lou here at the Pan American Center when the Aggies take on New Mexico.
Well, Long Beach is really struggling to control Huggins, who's playing with incredible confidence now.
Jermaine Haley gets it in for Jamario Jones. Huggins, there's that confidence. pinballs out his three. Jones keeps it alive. Endear to Jamario, and he's hammered underneath.
But, you know, he just gets bashed in the face, and he doesn't even flinch. I mean, really heads-up play by the Aggies to come up with this loose ball. And it was Jamario Jones who caused the turnover, then goes right at the basket. I mean, he's just, you know, he's just a wrench in the lawnmower at every turn.
How about these numbers, Coach? 2 years ago for Jamario at Hill Juco as a freshman, 13 points per game, 13 rebounds per game, 7 assists per game, and 2 blocks per game. He's flirting with a triple-double every night, going by those numbers as a freshman at the Juco level.
Yes, but he's not big enough to do it except if you count Hart. It seems that he's just got tremendous energy and exuberance.
And he was a really, really late sign. He was the last guy signed. I'm assuming had nowhere to go. He got a D1 offer from Paul Weir. By the way, Javonte Jackson now has 4 personals for Long Beach State. He's on the bench.
Well, there's a lot of time left. So just because Jamario Jones and Braxton Huggins are playing so well doesn't mean that we're done here.
Sean Prince will shoot free throws. He's an interesting story. He is a former Gatorade Player of the Year in California. And he went to high school in Long Beach. Went to Long Beach Poly High School. Was a top 100 recruit nationally. Went to USC out of high school in Long Beach and then transferred to Long Beach State after just 1 year with the Trojans. And now this is season 2 for him with the 49ers. A little undersized at 6'6". Front court guy, he's a junior. A little more pressure here from the Beach. And they drop back in a zone here again, Coach. Looks like a 3-2.
Well, it was an interesting move in the first half when Dan Munson went to the zone while he was winning by 10.
Quality set up by Haley for Baker, and maybe 2 open right there. Jermaine found him, and Ian said my bad to Jermaine Haley.
But I don't know. I don't believe my own eyes on that. But Ian Baker, I've never seen Ian Baker miss by that much before. We hardly ever see him miss anyway. Mm-hmm.
Bibbins on the hesitation. Blackwell from straight away. Boy, can he shoot it. Noah Blackwell has made 3 threes on 4 tries. Baker staying patient here now. Jermaine Haley, a 6'7 guard. On the maneuver, Huggins is bumped. And Braxton will get 1 in the bonus when we come back from break. That is team foul number 7. On Long Beach State. Huggins is 5 of 5 on free throws. He has scored 16, and he can add to that point total when we come back to Las Cruces. The Aggies lead by a half dozen.
Introducing a more pleasurable way to buy a car. Get a low-rate auto loan from White Sands Federal Credit Union even before you walk on the lot. White Sands Federal Credit Union. The difference is black and white. Introducing First Checking, a free checking account for kids between 13 and 17 years old. A First Checking account can help you teach your kids financial literacy. White Sands Federal Credit Union. The difference is black and white.
On the field,
in the pool,
on the court,
we wear our game faces under the lights.
But sometimes our toughest opponents aren't wearing a uniform.
Instead, we confront them internally.
Mental illness affects 1 in 4 adults in the United States.
Suicide is the second leading cause of death among college students.
If you or someone you know is fighting a silent battle, please speak up and ask for help.
You are not alone.
The Department of Family and Consumer Sciences at New Mexico State was recently ranked among the top Family and Consumer Sciences degree programs in the U.S. That's according to a national rankings website. The department was ranked 28th out of 50 by Great Value Colleges. The ranking was created based on graduate degree opportunities, research opportunities, and internship and scholarship opportunities. For more information, visit nmsu.edu. Adam Young and Russ Bradford back with you, former NM State assistant coach. It is 59-53. The Aggies lead by six.
There's our mayor, Ken Miyagashima.
Yes.
To the left.
He's a regular.
He is a regular.
We're going to take a peek here at the WAC preseason poll. NM State picked to win the WAC this year, but it could be a little close. Bakersfield certainly improved, and Grand Canyon improved, and we could see some other teams contend. UMKC's been pretty good in the non-conference.
Well, and the Aggies, I know, will be hungry after just coming within a hair of making the NCAA tournament yet again last spring.
And UMKC's probably had as good of a non-conference portion as anybody. They have Martez Harrison back, and he's one of the better guards in the league. Huggins 7 of 7 now on free throws. And the Aggie lead is up to 8. Aggies trying to double-team Bibbins, which is hard to do. And now Bibbins will set things up inside the center circle. Two high posts set for the Beach. Prince to a curling Blackwell. Feints from 18. Skips off the rim. Into the hands of Braxton Huggins and NM State. Baker's calling for it here near wing. Right back to Huggins. Clean look. Yes, sir.
Now, how they left Huggins open at that point, I know Dan Munson's got to be shaking his head. That's not in the game plan.
21 for Huggins on a 5 of 11 shooting, 4 of 9 on threes. Lead back in double digits. Ogilu pulls it out to the wing. Keep in mind, Levin and Javante Jackson both have four personals. Blocked by Haley, stick back, no. Tipped out to Jamario Jones. And he will wisely pull it out initially. Then he bounces for Baker. Wink pass to Haley. Stutters to the rim. Hand off Wilkins. He tried to slam it, and he was met at the cylinder by LaRon Williams.
Well, he was hit right in the air. I think everybody was so surprised that he missed that they didn't call a foul. He got literally got knocked out of the air.
And that was about as high a rate as I have ever seen Paul Weir when a foul was not called. On the block there by Williams.
Beautiful pass by we're at the other end.
Double-double now for Jamario Jones with 10 and 10. 10 points and 10 rebounds. Huggins, he's really feeling it. That was long. Offensive board to Wilkins, saves it to Baker. Aggies could match their largest lead with the deuce right here. Huggins for three again. Biggest lead tonight for the Aggies, and Huggins has 24. And now he's calling for a sub. He needs a breather. I think I would too, Coach. Well,
I don't know. I think he should get to Las Vegas and start gambling. He's so hot. And watch him. He's just got that beautiful, picture perfect shot. Just beautiful release. Took his time there.
Here's the thing too, Coach. It's nice to see him shoot with so much confidence. He's not fazed by a miss. I think last year and 2 years ago, maybe a little tentative.
Yeah.
When he should not shoot. Right now, he's not hesitating one bit. If he's open, it's flying.
No, yeah, and he's calm about it. He's making good decisions. He's not taking any bad shots.
So Huggins now has 24, 12 for Endier, 10 for Jamario Jones with 10 rebounds as well. And Huggins has connected on 5 of 11 threes. Beautiful looking shot. That's textbook if you want to teach how to shoot the basketball.
That's right.
That's what you teach.
Yeah, he just perfectly squared up. And he had a 6'9 player running at him there, as we see Dan Munson just trying to dig deep and get any kind of motivation for this road-weary team.
If NM State hangs on, that is 12 straight wins over Long Beach State in this building. NM State is home for 7 of their first 10 games. They're going to have New Mexico next Saturday, 7:30. The Aggies win this one, they go to 7-2. You get that one next Saturday, you're really feeling good.
Well, it should be an incredible game. I hope everybody comes out, even though it'll be delayed telecast, I guess, on Aggie Vision. Will it? But there's nothing like the Pan Am Center for a UNM New Mexico State game. It'll be a madhouse.
An 8-0 run here for the Aggies over the previous 2 minutes.
And here's an interesting move. Paul, we're going with a 1-3-1 zone with Jamario Jones on the top. Or what? Well, it's hard to tell. Maybe it's a 3-2.
It's a lot of length to deal with up top with Jamario. And Matt Taylor, too, for that matter. No call. And stepping out of bounds was Jamario Jones. Almost a shot clock violation there on Bibbins.
Well, Aggies might have got a break there. Justin Bibbins felt like he was fouled.
Bibbins quiet recently. He scored 8 early. In for Youssef. And one. Temedayo Youssef muscles one in.
Well, if Chua seems confused as to why it was a foul, but the Aggies are in trouble if your man catches it at 1 foot from the basket. I think Paul Weir agrees. He's got Jonathan Wilkins back in the game pretty quickly here.
Rounded in by Wilkins, and then he lost it out of bounds. So this could be a huge possession here for the Beach. 4 or 5 points in this possession. Bibbins off, and Warren Jackson right there, number 2 in gold, comes in. Tanvir Bular comes in for Wilkins for the Aggies.
Well, this is no time for the Aggies to take their foot off the gas pedal.
Bular's only played 1 minute, and I think he's whistled for a foul right here, trying to fend off Youssef. Foul on Tanvir, who only played 5 minutes Wednesday, had 2 points. He really slimmed down big time in the offseason. He's weighing in right now at 275. He was, I think, 350-ish at many points last year. He's 7'2". Loads of potential.
Yes, good hands, nice touch around the basket. Not quite as big as his big brother.
Sim is 7'5", and he's in the NBDL right now, correct?
Yes.
A brief stint in the NBA. Now his team foul number 7 on the Aggies, so bonus free throws for Youssef, who has a pretty good looking shot. He's 79% for the season. Took a medical redshirt last season. He's a sophomore from Oakland, California. And he gets 1 of 2. So he's 1 of 3 now from the free throw line. Three-quarter court pressure for Long Beach State. Aggies break it easily. Jones retreats out to the corner. 2-3 zone for Long Beach. And Haley throws it away. Into the hands of LaRonda Williams and a foul on Jamario Jones.
Well, Haley has a little bit of a bad habit, Adam. He'll throw one-handed passes, which the guards can get away with from time to time, but big guys should be avoiding it.
Taylor and Huggins in for Jones and Haley. That is the 4th on Jamario.
That's not good news.
Bonus free throws, LaRonda Williams, a redshirt freshman from Long Beach. Snatched in by Eli Chua. A lead of 11 for the Aggies on offense here. Trying to pull away from Long Beach State. A win would push the Aggie record to 7-2. Quite the start. Wilkins looking high-low. Keeps his pivot foot. Huggins falls away. Short tip in Eli Chua. Yeah,
beautiful tip. I think Huggins was hoping for the foul there. But again, the offensive rebound bails out the offense, makes the offense look a little bit better.
And Shua is playing with four personals right now. Four personals are Shua and Jamario Jones. Jackson bounces low block left, right hand hook in for LaRon Williams. Wilkins, there's the high-low. Shua doesn't even come down with it. And midair, he puts it in. Four straight for Eli.
And nice pass by Jonathan Wilkins.
That takes really good body control to stay in midair, not come down with it, and still finish. Youssef gets his own miss. Blocked away, Jonathan Wilkins, but it's going to stay with Long Beach State. 7:36 to go. Four Aggies now in double figures with the Aggies ahead by 13. Huggins 24, Endear 12, Shua 11, Jones 10. And the Aggies continue to be active defensively. A swat right there from Jonathan Wilkins.
Wells Fargo is making changes to make things right. First, all customers who have been impacted will be fully refunded. Second, a confirmation will be sent when new personal or small business checking, savings, or credit card accounts are opened. Third, we've eliminated product sales goals for our retail bankers to ensure your interests are put first. We're taking action. We're renewing our commitment to you.
Hey, sweet, a bike. Are you thinking of training?
Nah, I'm thinking of riding to work. You know, a little alone time.
We're not breaking up a carpool, right?
I'm just messing with you guys.
24/7 fraud monitoring, security, convenience, together.
Seriously, what's a bike for?
Wells Fargo, together we'll go far.
Started to shoot it well from three, 7 of 13 in the second half. Wednesday in their win against Air Force, and they're 8 of 19 from three here tonight, Coach. So shooting it well from three, and the main two guys have been City Endear right there, and also Braxton Huggins, who's filled it up with five made threes.
Yes, and we haven't really heard from Ian Baker, but it's been they've all been out of the out of the offense, in the flow of the game, not forced shots. So it looks good for the Aggies.
The Aggies have shot 53% from the field in this half. They've outscored the 49ers by 8, 30-22 here in the second stanza. The lead has grown to 13, behind 24 from Huggins. Blackwell triggers in. That's out of bounds. Jordan Griffin was out of bounds on the sideline in front of his bench.
Well, Aggies got a break there because the man who passed the ball in bounds, Noah Blackwell, was wide open. It would have went right back to him.
Turnover number 14 on LBSU. Baker speeds across the midcourt line. Wilkins trapped. Back on the wing for Baker. Wilkins thought about high-low, skips out to the sideline. Baker hard to the rim, and Ian Baker finishes.
Well, he looked like he got fouled on that one to me, but great body control by Ian Baker. Now somebody's got to slow down Bibbins here.
11, playing with four personal, spins and finger rolls it in with the left. Levin's been quiet. 9 points now for Gabe Levin in only 25 minutes. He has 5 rebounds, 4 of 7 shooting. The average is a team-high 13 coming in. Huggins always a threat now to shoot it. And he throws it away into the corner, into the hands of Bibbins. Zigzagging around defenders to the rim, no continuation. It was on the floor, but Bibbins will get free throws anyway, one of the bonus. With 6:32 to go.
Well, one of the things I noticed is how you wouldn't know by looking at Dan Munson or his bench that the team is 1-8. They seem like they're completely into it. I think they know what they've been up against and what the potential that lies ahead for them. But there's nobody on the bench hanging their head. They're not disgusted. The coach isn't abusive to the players or anything. He doesn't look like he's 1-8 at all.
And he'll be surprised if this is an NCAA tournament team with a losing record based on the strength of schedule they've had.
Do you think it's possible he knows what he's doing?
I think so. He's done it a few times before.
No, there's more than one way to skin a cat, and this is a very different way to approach the season.
He always scheduled tough when he was at Gonzaga. That was before Gonzaga became what it is now. Dan Munson, in his final year with the Zags, went to the Elite Eight in 1999. Picked up by Baker. Wilkins corrals it. And Huggins will have under 10 on the shot clock. Go to work, Braxton. What a pass by Eli Chua. Right back to Chua. Finger roll in. How about that feed?
That is an incredible play. I've never seen you jump out of your seat before, Adam. But yeah, there was just really beautiful play by Eli Chua.
From the corner, Griffin swishes in the three. He can shoot it. First made three tonight for Griffin on his fourth try. The creativity from Eli Chua. Who would even think to do that? Wilkins hands it off to Huggins. Splits defenders. And a foul is called on Prince. So Braxton can add to his point total of 24. He is 7 of 7 from the charity line tonight. 8th on Long Beach State, the 2nd on Roshan Prince. Here comes the fan favorite. Garza's in. Fans cheer. It's like Gordo Castile a few years ago when he would come in. The Las Cruces faithful would.
Well,
he embrace.
Maybe, there's going to be several fan favorites, though, I think, this year. And if Huggins keeps shooting like he is, he'll be one of them. But there's Jamario Jones just coming up with a rebound out of nowhere.
He'll take a travel right there for Paul Weir. That's pure hustle there from Jamario.
It just shows the confidence, though, that Paul Weir has with Joe Garza. He sticks him in the game with, 5 minutes to go. The game's still on the line.
Levin can't connect. And we'll go the other way. Frustration may be settling in just a little bit here.
Well, Gabe Levin, he fouls out. He's had a terrific year so far, and he's come out of nowhere, a kid with no scholarship offers out of high school, went to a prep school, went to Loyola Marymount and played great, but when they changed coaches, he left. From Oak Park River Forest High School in Chicago. Who else went there? What other greats? Ernest Hemingway.
Yes.
That's who.
There you go.
You might remember Hemingway. He was a great player himself.
When you don't have Evan Payne, too, that puts so much pressure on Levin to score, and just didn't have it tonight. Truly hope Evan Payne's okay. He did travel with the team. He's on their bench, in fact. He has his jersey on, but he has not played tonight.
No, and it could have been a very different story with him if he'd have been healthy.
In the hands of Endier. And he will wisely slow it down. Now he attacks. Endier leans in. Blocking foul. Garza's the first to meet him. 5:09 to play, 76-65 Aggies.
Well, that looks like...
That's the fifth on Javonte Jackson. So he'll be done as well. So Jackson and Levin fouling out here for the Beach. Jackson, a freshman from Compton, has a bright future for the 49ers. And another freshman who comes in for him, number 22 in goal, that's LaRon Williams. Second free throw for City. And he gets one of two. He showed flashes last year, but he's been so consistent this year. And a balanced scoring team. He's been the most consistent scorer for Paul Weir so far, nine games in.
And he may be the best defender of the guards.
Paul Weir said when he was hired, he told City Endear that this is the role that you need to play. Same with Eli Chua. I need you to be this type of a player. And both guys have bought in to what Paul Weir was wanting.
Well, just when we start saying too many good things about City, he takes a shot a little too quick.
Blocked away by Jamario Jones. He pinned that one against the backboard.
That's giving up 5 inches, too. I was about to jump out of my seat on that one. I mean, there's just he's just a really, as a former coach, I can tell you, he's a very like, just a guy who plays that hard and is that active.
Cross-court feed to Garza. High post Jones. Now Endear. City hesitation. Pull-up jumper from two. Rattles it through. Endear has 15. Long Beach State will need a big rally here. Rising up, Bibbin swishes in the J. He has 14 now, but only four of those in this half.
Well, I think City might need a break. Adam, he just looks a little bit worn down out there.
Huggins on the exchange, down the near lane. Here's Endear. Well, a little short.
Yes,
yeah.
and that's always a sign when
doesn't really have his legs under him here. Fresh 30 for the Aggies and Garza. And that was off Joe's knee, and it goes to Long Beach State. Media timeout, the final one tonight. Can NM State hang on? Looking for their fifth straight win. Also trying to move to 6-0 at home. The stat sheet stuffer, Jamario Jones, playing a role on both ends. The Aggies lead by 10.
If I lose, I'll respond with respect.
If I win, I'll back it up with humility.
If I fail, I'll rise up with honor. It's tough for us to put it all on the line.
Don't undo my hard work with poor sportsmanship.
Respect, it's the name of the game.
Buying a home? Don't forget to check the low-rate mortgage options offered by White Sands Federal Credit Union. White Sands Federal Credit Union. The difference is black and white. A home improvement loan from White Sands Federal Credit Union can help you make your home the best it can be. Unfortunately, we can't help you clean up. White Sands Federal Credit Union. The difference is black and white.
Notice how life's little mishaps never happen at a convenient time? The new Memorial Urgent Care at Sonoma is built around real families. Whether it's a fever, stitches, or dad's weekend project gone wrong, our friendly medical team at Memorial Urgent Care has you covered when it just can't wait. Open 7 days a week from 9 a.m. to 8 p.m. Memorial Urgent Care, priced right and conveniently located on the corner of Sonoma Ranch and Highway 70.
10 points and 13 rebounds for Jamario Jones. He's close friends with Ian Baker on this team, and Ian had some thoughts on his buddy and the JUCO transfer from Hill JUCO.
A lot of fun to put him on the team. He's just an outgoing person. He's fun to be around, wants to get better, and he's learning a lot. And he's just a good teammate to have.
There's Ian Baker. Baker has 11. Jamario has 10. Holiday night for those two. Five players in double figures, led by Huggins with 24. Two players in double figures for the 49ers. 14 for Bibbins, 13 for Blackwell. Both those guys are in right now. Check that. Yeah, Bibbins is in. There's a layup in for Lauren Jackson. Aggies have numbers. Endier almost had a lob there for Jamario. He wanted it. Oh, he wanted it. He's smiling there in the far corner.
Well, I think it was the right decision, though. They need the clock more than they need the basket, I'd say, at this point.
Endier's peeking up at the clock here with 8 to shoot. Bounces in the wing for Huggins. He'll make something happen. Huggins, long floater, 26 for the Bakersfield California native. He's hard to guard right now. He's doing everything, inside, outside. Jackson answers with a teardrop of his own. Baker double team, flies out of it to Endier. Lob ahead for Jones, 2 and change to go. As coach said, the Aggies will use some clock here. Shoe with the ball screen for Huggins. Shot clock is down to 5. Endier slipping, Jones catches, blocked away. Perry Ogilu met Jamario. 1:40 to play. Long Beach State with a 3 right here could really make this interesting. Back with the deuce, it's a 2 possession game. Blackwell from long distance, off the mark. Defensive rebound for Baker. That would have made it a 5-point game.
No, might have been an ill-advised shot with no Long Beach players under the board, but they're exhausted. So we see Lauren Jackson. His father was a highly regarded Chicago high school coach, but is coaching in Florida now.
Ian Baker will shoot 2 free throws. And he stays perfect here tonight. He is now 6 of 6. Trying to make this a 10-point advantage. And he does. 83 seconds left. Aggies trying to hang on for their 5th win in a row. Trying to go to 7-2 before a big rivalry game next weekend against New Mexico at home. Jackson, acrobatic, no. Rebound, though, for Ogilu, and a foul is called. It's on Jamario, I believe.
Yep.
That's his 5th. Yeah. Heck of an effort. 27 minutes, 10 points, 13 rebounds, 2 assists for just the Memphis, Tennessee native.
Just like junior college, where he was doing it at Hill Junior College.
Ogilu at 9 points in 9 minutes last game at Kansas. He's a transfer in from Yuba Community College. Elk Grove, California native. Both free throws. Got 1 of 2. Ogilu sends it in.
Well, that's just like a three-point play there.
7-point game. Robbins stolen by Bibbins. 1 minute to go. Blackwell back to Bibbins. Jackson trying to really make it interesting. And it's a 2-possession game. And Paul Weir calls it timeout.
Well, Eli Chua just with a couple sloppy passes there. He's just going to have to take better care of the ball.
That was essentially a 6-point sequence.
And he lobs it up and a 5'6" guy steals it.
It was a 10-point lead just moments ago. Ogilu made 1 free throw. Then he got his own miss, put it back in. And then a 3-pointer was good for Jackson. So essentially a 6-point sequence there in a matter of what? 10 seconds for Long Beach State.
That's not the way the Aggies want to finish. And if it keeps up for the next few seconds, they won't finish at all.
Both teams in the double bonus here. Some of the fans have left. It appeared This game was all but over. Full court pressure, of course, for Long Beach State. Aggies have Baker, Wilkins, Chua, Huggins, and Endier. 6-0, Long Beach State run, handoff, a dangerous one to Baker. No really, foul yet.
Really,
finally, Jackson fouls him.
Brilliant inbounds play set up by Paul Weir. The handoff to his best, you know, oldest player and best shooter. Really, really smartly done.
And if you're wondering how is Paul Weir X's and O's, that's what he's really known for. He's done a great job X's and O's, even during his assistant tenure leading up to his first year coaching as head coach.
That was just a really well executed, which was not at all what we saw a couple plays before when Eli Chua couldn't lob it over the 5'7" guy. And Chua's played well. I don't want to pick on Eli Chua. He's had a good game up to this point.
A&M State 24 of 29 on free throws. Baker hasn't missed yet. He is 8 of 8. Trying to make this a 6-point lead right here. Big free throw for Ian. DC native, lone senior for the Aggies. Really needed that one. And we know Bibbins can get down the court in what, 3 or 4 seconds?
That's right.
If he's hurrying.
Yes, he's like he's on a motorcycle.
All the way to the lane. Foul is called. And when you attack like that, you're bound to draw a foul, and Justin Bibbins did. So two free throws for him now. It's on Huggins. First on Braxton tonight. By the way, NM State has shot 30 free throws. This is only the 19th shot by the 49ers, and Bibbins missed it.
Well, that hurts.
He's 82% career. He missed both.
And Aggies can't get the ball back. This is not the way they want to finish. Although I will say, Adam, it's good for the Aggies to be in a close game, but not to fritter things away at the end.
And I think they're going to check the monitor to make sure it's going to be Long Beach State ball. The benefit of replay nowadays, huh? Appreciate Ruben Ramos coming over here to us and telling us what they're looking at.
Yes, but what did he say? Let's get him back here.
They're trying to see if it's Long Beach State ball or the Aggies, and that's the best angle that we have in the truck.
Well, they're not asking my opinion. Who should they come over and ask my opinion?
That might have been what he said.
Well, here it is again. Well,
I think Jonathan Wilkins may have gotten a piece on his follow-through. Maybe.
Well, evidently the referees agree with you. But that doesn't mean they're right, Adam.
And if they don't see enough to overturn it, they're going to stay with the original call.
No, it's a veteran crew here, and they've been pretty good all night.
Well, we're hunched over. Final 46 seconds right here. Ogalu fakes the pass, and he knocks it in for two. 4-point game. Chua's having issues, and he has to use a timeout. This doesn't feel great if you're the Aggies right now. Not a whole lot of breathing room ahead by only four, and Long Beach State all of a sudden has some confidence back.
No, that's right.
Confidence they probably didn't have 2 minutes ago. It was a 13-point game.
But let's see what Paul Weir draws up here to get the ball in bounds again. It wasn't any problem last time.
Ian Baker is doing some talking right now in the huddle as Paul Weir draws something up. We both got to see Paul work when he was the associate head coach under Marvin Menzies, and before that an assistant. And I always raved and was so impressed by the job he did, X's and O's wise, getting the team ready for opponents.
Oh, he's the first Aggie assistant in many years to have a national reputation.
Huggins gets by defenders. Chua's going to try to finish, and one, Eli Chua.
Well, Chua comes back from his, and he's played well all night. He made the one bad inbounds pass, but Huggins, seeing, smelling blood, and went all the way rather than bring it out, which I think he did the right thing. And Chua finishes strong.
Why not? If you have the points, take them. Aggies could get three right here. 3-point play at a crucial time for Eli Chua. 17 for Eli. A new season and career high for him. Quick timeout. Dan Munson after the Bibbins. Deuce. This is going to be a full for them. 88-81. They won't go away yet, and that was a big play, probably the play of the night right here, as Huggins doesn't get fouled, and Chua decides to go towards the hoop and finish anyway.
Yeah. And Bibbins, who's such a winner of a player, it's got to be the worst fall of his life, playing these, playing on the road 9 games in a row against very good teams. But they'll benefit from it once the Big West play starts, I think.
From watching tonight, good luck finding a better 1-8 team in America. This has to be the best one-win team.
That's right.
That has 8 losses in America.
That's right.
Once again, those 8 losses for them coming in, 6 against premier programs, North Carolina, Louisville, Wichita State, UCLA, Washington, and Kansas. And they're not playing any of those teams at Long Beach. They're going to Louisville. They're going to Chapel Hill. They're going to Lawrence, Kansas. They did have North Carolina at home a few years ago. I think Dan Munson and Roy Williams are good friends. They'll figure things out.
Now I think if the Aggies get the ball in here, if they even get the ball in bounds, Long Beach will have to foul just the minute it comes in bounds. They'll play for the steal, and if the Aggies catch it, they'll have to foul them right away.
Baker and Huggins, the two best free throw shooters. Well, Huggins bounces for Baker.
They're going to foul out here. Yeah.
Probably the third best free throw shooter on the team. City coming into this one, 74%. Not as good as Ian and Braxton, both above 80. And certainly a good option here for the Aggies at the charity line. Left to go. NM State is 26 of 31 on free throws.
Can you do that percentage quickly in your head? They're
up peaking.
Near 90%. Huh?
84%.
Oh.
I peaked.
All right. That doesn't count.
1 of 2 for City. Blackwell pushing for Long Beach State. Shot clock is off. Blackwell straight away in transition. Long, two of the rebound. And Long Beach State will foul, possibly for the final time tonight.
Well, Eli Chua redeemed himself after his inbounds pass. Really played well all night. And coming on strong here down the stretch.
And Chua's a guy who last year only played 7.5 minutes per game. He only appeared in 24 games, 24 of the 34. He had games where he did not even play. He was highly recruited out of high school. In a big sophomore year. That may do it. Aggies by 8. Clock moving. 15 seconds to go for Jackson. Now Blackwell with 12 seconds. Tough look. Huggins had his hands on it. Bibbins tracked it down. Bibbins splitting defenders to the rim. Lays it in with 5.9. Makes it a 6-point game, and we'll see if Long Beach State will foul here or not. Lob in for Huggins. Out of bounds, and it goes to the Aggies. They're fighting until the final whistle. Give them a ton of credit.
Yes. That's what I mean about it. I think this is all part of Dan Munson's grand plan. It might not look pretty now, but I think he's got things going on that...
Well, they foul City, and Dan Munson did not want that. Jordan Griffin fouled him, and Dan Munson shook his head. Not what he wanted with 2.9 to go. Yeah. Two free throws for City. Now for him. There's a peek at the Aggie bench. So many guys contributing here tonight. Balanced scoring effort again. 18 for Endear, 26 for Huggins, 15 for Baker, Shua 19. A lot of guys in double figures, 10 for Jamario Jones. And Paul Weir's Aggies, they are 7-2. They have started 6-0 at home. Best home start since 08-09. And the final score is 93-85, with the Aggies defeating Long Beach State for the 12th straight time inside the Pan American Center. Paul Weir is going to come over here and join us. NM State will have New Mexico next Saturday. Next week is finals week, so the Aggies do not have a game during the week. And the Aggies will have New Mexico next Saturday here at home, and they'll try to go to 8-2. When they take on the Lobos. Next two games are rivalry games, New Mexico and then at UTEP, and UTEP is sputtering right now. So we'll see how that fares for the Aggies. Paul Weir is making his way towards us. NM State now 71-6 in their previous 77 home games. Braxton Huggins scored 26 here tonight for the Aggies to pace the Aggie effort. He made 5 threes. New Mexico State shot well from the arc. They win 93-85. We're pleased to be joined right now by the head coach, Paul Weir. Long Beach State made it interesting late, coach, but your team able to finish him off and get a great win.
Yeah, big win, ugly win, really rough defensive night, but we made shots. They went zone, which was great. We got a lot of open looks and made some shots. We got in a really good rhythm offensively, and we're able to withstand a poor defensive effort.
How about the confidence that Braxton Huggins is playing with offensively right now?
Yeah, no, he was really rolling, had a couple of rough games there. But again, tonight when they went zone, it really opened up the game for him, and we were able to get some great looks. And then once they went back man from there, we were in a really, really good rhythm. And that's happened to us here a couple times in the past few games. We had a bit of a lull offensively. We've opened it up in the zone. And then when it goes back to man, we're back in a really good rhythm. So offensively, I felt pretty good about how we did tonight. It's just defensively, it just wasn't good enough.
You have to be satisfied with how many guys are contributing right now offensively. It's somebody different each possession, it seems like.
That's the idea. That's what we've been trying to preach all year long, really since the fall. This is a team effort. It's about the guy next to you, different guy every night, play a lot of players, play up and down, play fast-paced, and hopefully do this thing as a team.
Coach, appreciate the time as always.
Thank you very much.
That's the head coach, Paul Weir. His team victorious over Long Beach State, 93-85 is the final, behind 26 from Huggins. And the Aggies shot 50% from the field. Post-game show next from Las Cruces.
The white lines keep time for you. Like road signs, my words are true. They bring me slowly back.
I missed you.
Did you bring new ones?
You work hard for more than just you.
You went to Montana.
I did.
Working together, we'll help you save for her future geology degree. Wells Fargo. Together we'll go far.
Finance your car with White Sands Federal Credit Union, and you don't have to make the first payment for 90 days. White Sands Federal Credit Union. The difference is black and white. Skip a payment twice a year with any auto or personal loan from White Sands Federal Credit Union. White Sands Federal Credit Union. The difference is black and white.
Notice how life's little mishaps never happen at a convenient time? The new Memorial Urgent Care at Sonoma is built around real families. Whether it's a fever, stitches, or dad's weekend project gone wrong, our friendly medical team at Memorial Urgent Care has you covered when it just can't wait. Open 7 days a week from 9 a.m. to 8 p.m. Memorial Urgent Care, priced right and conveniently located on the corner of Sonoma Ranch and Highway 70.
A&M State scores 93 tonight for their fifth straight win. They beat a quality program in Long Beach State. 93-85 is the final. Hey, Aggie
Hello,
fans,
Tom
we
Designs.
Hope you join us for our new show, A&M State Aggie Profiles. A&M State and Aggie Vision will take you inside the lives of some of the best athletes on campus. You can check local listings for showtimes on Fox Sports Arizona, Fox College Sports, Altitude TV, and also KRWG. And then you can catch an encore of the show on Aggie Vision's YouTube channel the very next day. Adam Young, joined by former A&M State assistant coach Ron Bradbird once again here during the postgame show. Nice win for the Aggies. Paul Weir wants improvement defensively, but you put up 93 against a pretty good defensive team in Long Beach State. You have to be happy with that.
That's right, and they played hard. They played together, and this is all with the big Lobo game coming in a week. So it would have been easy for the Aggies to say, this is going to be an easy game. Let's focus on the Lobos, but they didn't.
Right before finals week as well. Let's take a look at the final highlights from this one. So much offense after kind of a slow start offensively, especially from the Aggies. Long Beach State wasn't much better early, but both teams eventually got going. It was 41-36 Aggies at halftime, and Eli Chua scored in a multitude of ways here tonight. He finishes with a new career high, and we see him knocking a three right there. Justin Bibbins, hard to stop. Noah Blackwell gets free for a three. Blackwell shot it well, 3 of 7 from three. He scored 13 points for Long Beach State, but we raved all night about that guy, Jamario Jones.
What great hustle and what great energy. It's like he's on 6 cups of coffee all the time.
Jamario Jones finishes with a double-double. He scores 10 points and grabs 13 rebounds in the Aggie win. And we saw a little more, again, from Jonathan Wilkins, gradually producing more and more in the offensive end.
Yes, he's coming out of whatever lull he was in, because he was such a big factor in the last couple of years, and maybe just missing Pascal Siakam, who's in the NBA.
Both teams played well offensively in the second half. Long Beach State scored 49 points. The Aggies with 52. This was a nice fast break. Jones to Haley, and then a transition three for City Endear. Endear finishes with 18 on 4 of 9 shooting. He was great from the free throw line, 8 of 10. For City. Gabe Levin was quiet. Only 9 points. There's 3 of his 19 right there. He also fouled out and only played 26 minutes. But individually, the story was Braxton Huggins. 26 points, made 5 threes, 7 of 8 on free throws. And there were junctures where he just took over.
Yeah, just really, but always played within himself. Didn't take a bad shot. Aggie's struggling here a little bit at the end to finish things off. But I'm not sure that's all bad, where they'll take it seriously from here on in.
Give credit to Long Beach State. They fought at the end. They pulled within 4, but a big and one there from Eli Chua was able to hold off the Long Beach State comeback. Final stats, love the shooting numbers. Rebounding numbers pretty good for the Aggies, and the turnover number was low. The free throws, I guess, Coach, the difference?
Well, that's right, and Aggies slashing to the basket over and over again. And it was a good game. I know Paul Weir is concerned about Aggie turnovers, as every head coach is, but the Aggies took pretty good care of the ball tonight.
Huggins led all scorers with 26, and Bibbins is the man who paced Long Beach State with 18. 6 of 12 shooting for Bibbins, 10 in the first half, 8 in the second half for him. He was probably the best point guard the Aggies have seen so far this year. Our Whataburger play of the game, a little tough to pick. There were some plays that we could have chosen, but we end up choosing the Eli Chua and one towards the end. Braxton Huggins doesn't get fouled here. Thought maybe Jackson or Ogulu would foul him. He doesn't get fouled, and Eli Chua gets a huge and one when the Aggies really needed it.
Yeah, sort of the nail in the coffin there, and great hustle by Eli Chua to get down the floor that quickly at his size.
You have to love the 7-2 start if you're Paul Weir. Really rolling now into 2 rivalry games. This is a big 2-week stretch coming up. You have New Mexico next Saturday. The following week you have UTEP, and you also have finals week. So you have to kind of manage how much practice time you have, how much study time you have. This is going to be interesting to see how that all pans out.
That's right. And as an English professor, Adam, I want you to talk about finals time first. But yes, it's very true, and it's an exciting team. It's a fun team to watch with only one senior, and just they come with great energy, which has been, of course, Paul Weir's trademark since he got here. So I think I'll be surprised if it's not packed next Saturday night for the big Lobo showdown.
The Aggies continue to protect the home court, 71-6 in their previous 77 home games, 6-0 on top of Lou Henson Court this year. Join us for our next telecast. It's tomorrow, Sunday, December 4th, when NM State women's basketball tips off against Arizona at 1 p.m. Tonight's broadcast was a co-production of staffs and students at New Mexico State. On behalf of all the talented students on our crew, my partner Russ Bradbird, I'm Adam Young saying thanks for watching. This telecast is copyrighted by the Regents of New Mexico State. Once again, the Aggies beat the 49ers by 8, 93-85, 26 for Huggins. We say goodnight from Las Cruces.
Hello, Totten Designs. A sales department? Yes, I can put you right through. Sales department, this is Nate.
Human resources.
Technical support.
Hold, please.
You work hard to grow your business.
Yes. I can totally do that for you.
Working together, we can help your business thrive. Wells Fargo. Together we'll go far.
We strive to achieve excellence through determination and hard work.
We are committed to learning from those around us, our professors and peers,
our coaches and teammates,
and our opponents.
We compete with integrity and passion.
And we seize our moment when the opportunity arises.
We take pride in our communities.
And believe that we can inspire others just as they can inspire us. We may wear different colors, but we share the same purpose.
We learn, we compete, we inspire.
We are
the Western Athletic Conference.
And here we have 1893 from the makers of Pepsi Cola. I'm gonna swirl it. I'm gonna smell it. I'm just gonna take one small sip.
Kinda seemed like more than a sip.
Yeah, let me show you. Refined.
1893, made with cola nut extract and real sugar. Boldly blended colas.
For Vegas-style action, play the hottest table games now at the casino at Sunland Park. Go all in for a great time with exciting electronic blackjack and stay, hit, or play your way to winning big. Or place your bets on electronic roulette, where a jackpot could be yours with any spin of the wheel. Vegas-style action, baby, you bet. Let your hot streak begin. The casino at Sunland Park, I-10 to Sunland Park, exit 13.
Play responsibly. Helpline 1-800-572-1142.